crucial game between two teams in the thick of the race in the Legends Division in the Big Ten. It's Nebraska and Northwestern. Bob Beschusen, Danny Cannell, Maria Taylor. Here with you just north of Chicago. It is a sold-out crowd. There's plenty of purple. There's also plenty of red here as the Nebraska fans have invaded Evanston. For Danny Cannell, a game that matters tremendously, not just to both of these teams, but in the wider angle lens, the race in the Legends Division, and who might eventually play in Indianapolis Big Ten Championship game.
Without question, you look at what's taking place across the Big Ten, it is anyone's game right now. And both these teams should be playing with an extreme sense of urgency, because it really is. It's playoff time. Even though it's regular season, but you are getting to that time of year and you have got to come out on top.
Nebraska won the toss, deferred their option to the second half, so the Huskers will kick it away to the Wildcats, and Benrick Mark is back deep to receive the kick of Brett Maher. Returnable from the nine. And Benrick Mark will set his team up with pretty good field position out to the 30-yard line. Austin Williams made the stop. So Northwestern, a multiple offense with a multiple, in many ways, dangerous quarterback in Kane Coulter.
Oh, without a doubt, Kane Coulter is an exciting player to watch. The biggest key is, where will he line up on the field? He'll line up in the backfield as a running back. He'll take the slot as a wide receiver. And he'll go out outside as a wideout. Here he is in his favorite position, though, and that's quarterback.
A little play-action fake for Coulter on first down. Wants to throw it, tucks it under, and he'll pick up a yard. Eric Martin made the stop for Nebraska, but good coverage in the secondary as the Huskers were not fooled by the play-action fake.
Not at all. Northwestern coming out with a play-action pass on first down, trying to get Nebraska to come up there, get a lot of guys in the box, but a nice job at their secondary covering everybody downfield.
Henrik Mark, a little cutback run to the 35-yard line for 4 yards. It'll be third down and five for a Northwestern team that is last in the Big Ten throwing the football. They're a team that still likes to live with the running attack, and now they bring in Trevor Siemian as they'll use Kane Coulter as a slot receiver right. So the backup quarterback, well, I guess the dual threat passing quarterback, comes in on third and five.
This is where you'll see him in third down passing situations.
Siemian looking for Coulter, and it's knocked away. Siante Evans, the nickel specialist for Nebraska, creates the three and out, and the Huskers will get the football.
Here's a look, Kane Coulter. You see him on the inside of the slot right there. Number 17, Siante Evans, comes up and presses him. That's one thing that's going to be a challenge for Kane Coulter. You got to remember, he is a natural quarterback, not used to getting off jams by opposing defenses. Pretty good job there by Nebraska.
Brandon Williams to punt. Wobbly spiral that forces Amir Abdullah into a fair catch at the Nebraska 25-yard line. So 40-yard punt, no return. And now Taylor Martinez will take over for the first time. And the number one rush offense in the Big Ten, the number five rush offense in the country,
40 yards
at 292 yards per game, gets their first crack at it.
They have so many weapons in that backfield, puts a tremendous amount of stress on opposing teams' front seven. And then they work in a little play-action pass as well. So they're going to keep this Northwestern defense guessing all afternoon.
Two tight ends on first down. Play-action fake. Martinez wants the bomb for Kenny Bell. Tripped up, and there's the flag. The feet got tangled with Nick Van Hoos. He was man for man with Kenny Bell. And Bell, obviously a sophomore with blazing speed. Their feet got tangled and the flag came out.
Much like Northwestern started off with a play-action pass, so did Nebraska. But they had the opportunity.
There is no foul on the play. Second down.
Now they'll pick the flag up.
Here's a look at the end of the play. You see the feet running so close. And all that happens, Kenny Bell just stumbles. Nick Van Hoos didn't even touch him, so a good no call by the officials. But, that was a missed opportunity for Nebraska to hit on a big play.
So it's second down and 10. Another play fake by Martinez. Swings one on the right flat, and that's caught by Ben Cotton, the tight end. And a flag comes out late as Cotton's bumped out of bounds.
Boy, that'll drive a head coach nuts right there. Ibrahim Campbell, the late hit. Just not a very smart football play right there.
Personal foul, 24, defense, late hit, out of bounds. 15 yards, automatic, first down.
So Ibrahim Campbell, the sophomore safety, after a moment ago, one 15-yard flag was dodged by Northwestern. Ibrahim Campbell picks up a second 15-yard penalty to set Nebraska up with great field position now at their own 44. Burkhead's first carry. He's got room. Upended after a gain of 8. Ibrahim Campbell made over with a flip down of Burkhead, but not before he sets up second down and 2.
Good look from the pit. You see those big Cornhusker linemen. What a great movement off the ball. Pushing that defensive line of Northwestern 3 or 4 yards down the field.
Play action on second and 2. Up the left side of the field, wide open is Quincy and Nunmo. And just like that, Nebraska's in the red zone. Anunmo lost the football. Officials say down by contact, a gain of 30. And it's first and 10 at the Northwestern 18.
Here's a look at the play. Watch the crossing route right there. When you're running the ball so successfully, you get teams to sneak up and that start getting those linebackers poking their head in the backfield. When you do that, you can drop play action passes in right behind them, just like they did right there.
Taylor Martinez on a quarterback keeper. Gets to the sideline. Bumped out of bounds, about a yard shy of a first down. Inside the 10 at the 9 by Daniel Jones. Looks like they'll actually mark him down at the 10-yard line. A gain of 8. Sets up second down and 2. Taylor Martinez averages about 57 yards per game or so rushing. A lot of different players can carry the football for the Huskers.
Nebraska going up tempo, getting to the line, gives Taylor Martinez a chance to survey the field and check out like he's doing here.
Back to the shotgun. He wants the lob, right corner of the end zone for Jamal Turner, and it's knocked away. Ibrahim Campbell has been busy, and that time he face guarded Turner. No flag comes out, it'll be third down and 2 at the 10.
Ibrahim Campbell, even though he's beat on the pass, does a nice job getting his hands up, getting somehow to get that ball deflected to keep Jamal Turner from making that touchdown catch.
Third down and 2. What do the Huskers dial up here? The number 1 rushing offense against the number 2 rush defense in the Big Ten.
I say you keep it on the ground.
They will with Burkhead. A stutter step and he goes nowhere. So it'll be fourth down at the 10-yard line. David Wabusi, Daniel Jones combine on the tackle for Northwestern, and it'll be a field goal attempt.
Watch the linebackers all fill up instantly. They read those offensive linemen. They see the run block technique, fill those holes perfectly, and Rex Burkhead has nowhere to go.
So it's Brett Maher. 27-yard attempt. And he sneaks it through. So Nebraska takes the early 3-0 lead over Northwestern. Maher, a former walk-on, replaced Alex Henry, who's gone on to the NFL. He's the Big Ten kicker and punter of the year last year as a junior. And now in a senior season, gives Bo Pelini's team the early field goal lead. And Bo Pelini not pleased that his team stalled. And he plays 65-yard scoring drive, not a touchdown drive, though.
He's always full of emotion, animation. You love playing for a guy like that who lays it all on the line every week. Obviously, there was some miscommunication there. My guess is it was a substitution maybe late on the kicking team. That look of frustration right there. Nonetheless, pretty solid drive for Nebraska opening up the game. Missed the one shot they had. I thought they had a chance for a touchdown to Kenny Bell, but other than that, passing the ball pretty successfully.
Maher to kick it off again. This one's got some hang time, and this one is deep. No chance for Vendrick Mark to bring it out. So that will come out to the 25 for Northwestern. Coulter on first down. After three downs and out on their opening drive, Coulter takes a sack on their fourth play from scrimmage. Back to his own 23-yard line, Cameron Meredith. His third sack of the season. It's a two-yard loss.
Boy, number 51, Will Compton, the middle linebacker for Nebraska, came on a delayed blitz. That pressure was one of the reasons Kane Coulter had to take that sack.
Read option, Vendrick Mark tries to get outside, and he's brought down for no gain on second down. Now it's third down and 12.
Well, one of the things defensive coordinator for Nebraska, John Papucha, said to us during the week is, hey, we want to come out and dictate the game to Northwestern. And that's what they're doing so far. They're playing with a lot of aggression, bringing some linebackers, trying to force Northwestern's hand. And that, for me, that would be, hey, you guys have got to put the ball in the air to beat us.
So now it's Trevor Siemian back in at quarterback on third down and 12. Mike Trumpy to his right in the backfield. Four-man rush, Siemian well protected over the middle. And dragging across the middle is Tony Jones, but he is well short of a first down. Stanley Jean-Baptiste brought him down. So that's back-to-back offensive possessions, Danny, for Northwestern, and back-to-back three and outs.
And they're still clearly feeling their way around this Nebraska defense, who they had so much success with last year. But looking at that game, you know, that was the first time Nebraska had seen Kane Coulter and company. Now they've got that film to coach up their players. So they're going to recognize things a lot quicker, and that's showing up early in this game. Now the question is, can Northwestern adjust offensively to counter?
Brandon Williams for the second time to punt, trying to keep it away from Amir Abdullah. And he has done that beautifully. Abdullah lets it roll all the way down to the 12-yard line. Terrific punt by Brandon Williams, 59 yards. And a directional kick to make sure it was nowhere near Amir Abdullah. Abdullah makes a mistake, though, by not moving over to make the catch. And costs his team some field position.
It was funny talking to Pat Fitzgerald, the head coach of Northwestern, said, hey, what are you going to do with Amir Abdullah? He laughed, said, no chance is he getting that ball. We're going to kick it away from him all day long.
Instead of the 13-yard line for Nebraska. Burkhead on first down. A gain of 3 yards. Out to the 16. Damian Proby made the stop. For those of you just joining us, welcome to a sold-out Ryan Field here in Evanston. A very important game in the Legends Division of the Big Ten between Nebraska and Northwestern. Bob Beschusen, Danny Cannell, Maria Taylor here. Taylor Martinez finds Kenny Bell on second down and 6. About 2 yards shy of a first down as we take a look at what we've had so far. Nebraska with the early 3-0 lead. A big hookup from Taylor Martinez on the opening drive for the Huskers to Quincy Enunwa. But then a third down stop at the 10-yard line of Rex Burkhead that forced a medium-range field goal from Brett Maher. Now third down and about 2, just shy of the 23-yard line for the Huskers, and they are able to move the chains, it looks like, out to about the 24. Chance Carter brought down Rex Burkhead, but Bo Pelini's team forcing Northwestern, Danny, off the field, 3 downs and out on both of their first 2 offensive possessions. They kick a field goal, and that is worrisome for Huskers fans. You don't want to see Rex Burkhead, who injured his knee back in their opening game and missed the next couple of games. We'll check in on Rex Burkhead's status, as Bo Pelini obviously concerned, when we return. While we were away, Rex Rex Burkhead limped off the field, and the training staff for Nebraska continues to look at his left knee. Now the Huskers average 292 yards per game on the ground. Number one in the Big Ten, number five in the country. But 98 of those 292 yards per game, at least in the games that Rex Burkhead has played this season, belong to him. Sixth in school history, crossing the 3,000-yard barrier last week and a couple of weeks ago. In four games this season, he's averaging about 100 yards per game. But a knee injury cost him the better part of three games to open the season. And now with Taylor Martinez set to go on first and 10, the official stop play. So it's Amir Abdullah, who has been terrific in the games where Burkhead has not been able to play.
Am I ready?
Well, I think the biggest concern with Rex Burkhead on the bench right now is he's the emotional, the heart and soul of this Nebraska offense. That would be my biggest concern if you're Bill Pelini.
Play action for Martinez under some pressure. Flushed out of the pocket. Nowhere to go. Taylor Martinez goes down at the 18-yard line. Damian Proby ends up with the sack. Let's go down to Maria.
Yeah, Rex Burkhead has taken the knee brace off of his knee. The training staff checked him out. He has not put it back on, and it looks like they're adding ice to his knee. They don't do injury reports unless it comes from head coach Bo Pelini, guys. But I would say that it's not looking like he's going to be back in this game.
Yeah, especially if you're wrapping it right there with ice. That's typically a sign of you're shutting the guy down.
Sprint out of the pocket for Martinez. Hoists one down the sideline. Tips. And incomplete. Intended for Jamal Turner. It'll be third down and 16 coming up for Nebraska as we take a closer look at Taylor Martinez, who is a dual threat quarterback in every sense.
Well, he had such a great start to the season, really eliminated a lot of mistakes that he made his freshman and sophomore season. But he had his worst performance in their last game against Ohio State. And that throw that we just saw, that was a freshman-like throw out of Taylor Martinez. That ball was up for grabs and could have been picked off. He's got to make smarter decisions.
Martinez flips one off his back foot underneath. He's able to make a connection well short of the first down to Amir Abdullah. As Abdullah gets out close to the 25-yard line, Daniel Jones brought him down, so that helps Nebraska slightly from a field position standpoint, but Bo Pelini's team goes backwards, and he is displeased.
he always looks displeased, though, which most great coaches do look like that on the sideline. They expect greatness out of their players. And
low snap scooped up by Maher, and a wobbly punt. Henrik Mark lets it roll, and then touches the football. Did he get it back, or does Nebraska have it?
Nebraska's
got it. The Huskers have it at the 11-yard line. Two mistakes by Henrik Mark, it looked like, letting it bounce in the first place, and then going after a rolling ball after he let it bounce.
Yeah, as soon as that ball hits the ground, you have got to run in the other direction, because that ball does some funky things when it starts rolling. And I know he was trying to do his best to save yardage, to get that ball and prevent his offense from getting pinned back, but that is the worst thing you could do.
Ben Cotton, the tight end, comes up with the fumble recovery after a 58-yard punt.
And the officials having a discussion right now to see which team touched it first, but as we saw, it was pretty clearly it was Venrick. There's a penalty on the field as well.
Personal foul, number three of the kicking team. That penalty will be reinforced. 15 yards, previous spot, repeat, fourth down.
Wow.
What a huge break for Northwestern. And Venrick Mark can breathe a huge sigh of relief. He gets another shot at this return in what could have been a costly mistake.
Well, they've got a couple number threes to play for Nebraska. Damian Stafford wears three on the defensive side, so he's guilty of the penalty. And what a huge turnaround that is. And is there a college football player anywhere in America breathing a deeper sigh of relief than Venrick Mark right now, as he'll get another chance, and this will put Maher back in his own end zone to wipe away the turnover and change field position all at the same time. better punt. Mark fields it, and it's returnable. Benrick Mark gets to the edge. To the 42-yard line of Nebraska. DJ Smith made the tackle, but Northwestern gets the football back. They avoid disaster based on the personal foul. And we'll step aside.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by K Jewelers. Every kiss begins with K. And Chevy, from kickoff to the last yard, Chevy runs deep.
The Dearborn Observatory Telescope here at Northwestern, built back in 1859, and they still use it. Well, here's the play a moment ago that radically changes things, and Damian Stafford, Danny Cannell called for the personal foul on the punt.
And this is going to be a real foolish penalty that Bo Pelini is not going to be pleased with. You see the little tussle back there, and then watch him keep following him right there in the back. You cannot do that. That is just not smart football.
Not only does it change possession, but changes field position by about 50 yards.
A huge change.
Trevor Siemian starts off at quarterback. He wanted the bubble screen right. Now he comes back underneath to Kane Coulter left. Quarterback to quarterback, and Coulter runs a long way to pick up about a yard. Stafford made the stop. It'll be second down and 9.
Well, you know Kane Coulter, you know him as a quarterback, but when he splits out at wide receiver, he's also a huge part of this Northwestern offense.
They've got numbers to the near side. That ball tipped though up in the air. It's a jump ball, and it looks like as if it will turn into a Northwestern reception. Christian Jones avoids what could have been another turnover possibility as we take a look at our impact players for Northwestern, brought to you by Chick-fil-A. And it's all about the quarterbacks.
Yes, it is. We've talked already a lot about Kane Coulter. You can see him there without a football. That's where he's most dangerous. And then Trevor Siemian, the more pocket passer who likes to target Kane Coulter quite a bit as a receiver. And they will move him all around in motion. They'll put him outside. They'll put him inside the slot. And even sometimes in the backfield next to Siemian.
It's Coulter back at quarterback. Quarterback draw on third down and about 10. And he won't come close to a first down. Great job by the Huskers defense to bail out Damian Stafford and get the stop on a drive that begins in plus territory. And the Wildcats will have to punt.
John Papuchis right there has got to be pleased with the way his Nebraska team is playing. They wanted to get off to a fast start. But then I think the key for them is, can they finish? They started great against Ohio State and then kind of let off the gas. That'll be the thing to watch this afternoon for Nebraska is, can they keep that pedal to the metal?
Brandon Williams with some hang time, trying to pin the Huskers deep. You gotta love the natural grass field. You can hit that wedge shot, spins to about a foot away from the end zone. Terrific punt by Brandon Williams, and the Huskers backed up when we come back. ESPN College Football coming to you as we felt the need to show you based on those pictures just outside of Chicago. We are not in Lincoln. Although you scan the stands and some of the camera angles we'll give you today, that pretty much makes it look like we're in Lincoln. There's a sea of red here at Ryan Field. Amir Abdullah for about a yard and a half as we take a look at the impact players for Nebraska. Presented by Chick-fil-A.
Well, there's such a strong rushing attack. Rex Burkhead obviously on the bench right now with an injury. Amir Abdul will be replacing him. And then Kenny Bell, their deep threat on the outside. And then Will Compton, the heart and soul of their defense, their leading tackler. He flies around the field constantly.
Abdullah driven back again. May have gained a yard. It'll be third down and long, coming up on 4 minutes to go. In the first quarter, as we take a look at Danny Cannell's keys. I always learn something when we bring these up.
Well,
for
Taylor Martinez, he's got to reclaim some of that earlier in the season, put that game against Ohio State behind him. And then defensively, they have to contain Kane Coulter. They've done a phenomenal job of it to this point in the game, but they're going to have to account for him all afternoon long.
Third down and 8. Play action. Martinez in the end zone. Shovels one forward to no man's land. If that's intentional grounding, it's a safety. Was there a player nearby?
There was not. These officials are going to talk. And he is going to say
number 81 from the offensive team was in the area on the pass. Incomplete, fourth down.
Chichi Araguzo just about forced the safety. But the officials say Ben Cotton was nearby.
The tight end was trying to get there. Look at Taylor Martinez. He gets in trouble early. He's so athletic. You see number 81, he's trying to come. You'll see him coming into the screen late. But really, I mean, Martinez just flipped that ball out there.
I still didn't see him.
I think they might have caught a break there.
So Maher from the back of the end zone, and now flags fly. Before the snap, did the play clock wind down?
Delay. Offense.
Wow.
Half the distance. Still, fourth down.
And what was already a precarious situation. Keep an eye on the tight end who comes across the field right there.
No way.
I mean, he is nowhere near that pass.
No way. That's a safety. That should have been intentional grounding. At least certainly seemed to be the benefit of the doubt given to Nebraska. Venrick Mark back in plus territory. Driven back at about the 47-yard line. So, again, very good field position for Northwestern, but it's a Wildcats offense that now has the ball for the fourth time. They have no first downs to this point. So, 3-3 and outs to start off the game.
And this, for me, is a critical drive for Northwestern, for their offensive coordinator, Mick McCall, to kind of see what he has learned in those first three possessions. Has he been able to find something where he can make an adjustment and try to counter? Because right now, Nebraska has all the answers for everything they've thrown.
It will be Trevor Siemian at quarterback.
The pocket passer.
Tally is open. Scoots up the sideline and picks up 4 yards. It'll be second down and six. And we've got the number one team in the land on ESPN tonight. A.J. McCarron and the Crimson Tide head to Knoxville to take on Tennessee. College football primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. Top-ranked Alabama against the Vols tonight at 7 on ESPN. Also live, watch ESPN. That's a dropped pass for what would have been the first down for Northwestern. Christian Jones couldn't hang on, so now it's third down and six at the 45.
Trevor Siemian, the pocket passer at quarterback for Northwestern, he can place the ball in tight windows. That was a tight throw right there. Christian Jones has got to make that catch. Would have been spectacular, but you've got to make those for your QB.
Kane Coulter is the newest man to the tackle box. Trips to the left, and that's where Siemian wants to go. High pass intended for Coulter. That's incomplete. That's 4 3 and outs for Northwestern to start the game, including 2 3 and outs on drives that began in plus territory.
Something showing up early here by Nebraska. They're challenging Northwestern's wide receivers. They're getting up in their face. They're pressing them. And that, to me, shows a lot of confidence in your athleticism, your ability to stay with the weapons for Northwestern.
Turned it over. He did. Inside his own 15-yard line, it goes back to Northwestern.
The ball in the hands, just right through the wickets, and then can't find the football. And Northwestern alert all over. That's Nick Van Hoos with the recovery. So now Northwestern, can they take advantage of this? They haven't been able to move the ball at all offensively. This time they'll try Kane Coulter at the quarterback position.
The third time that Northwestern begins a drive in plus territory. Coulter, play action fake, under some pressure. Somehow escapes. All the way down to the 6-yard line. It'll be second down and two. He should have been sacked.
That is nothing else but just sheer athleticism right there on behalf of Kane Coulter. This ball is designed to go down the field. You see Kane Coulter, a little play action pass, looking for his tight end. Gets out, and Nebraska has him. They have him right there, but he slips two defenders and then picks up another 7 yards, 8 yards.
Second down and two at the 6. Coulter on a keeper. this time he will go down. Loses 4 yards back to the 10. P.J. Smith not fooled by the fake. It'll be third down. And about six from the 10.
Kane Coulter running that zone read play down the line of scrimmage. And Nebraska has been talking all week about containing him. They're going to have to stay responsible to their assignments, which they did almost to perfection right there.
Coulter comes off the field. Simeon back in the game. How hard is this on the quarterback, coming cold and running on third down?
It is a challenge. I think this is a good thing that Coulter's off the field because he doesn't get locked into him.
Simeon finds a man at the 5-yard line for a walk-in touchdown.
Simeon,
it's Dan Vitale. Touchdown pass on the season for Trevor Siemian. And Northwestern on the verge of scoring 7 after Amir Abdullah muffed the punt. The first down of the game for the Wildcats is a touchdown that gives them the lead.
Dan Vitale, the super back, as they like to call him, playing an H-back position. You'll see him come from the left side of the screen. Just a short crossing route. Nebraska can't keep in, and he takes it in on his own.
And Vitale with his first touchdown catch of the season after Amir Abdullah on the right muffed the punt. So that turnover becomes 7-4 Northwestern. And the Wildcats take a 7-3 lead. Let's go back to the touchdown.
Here's a look at the play. You're going to see a mesh route. Two guys are going to cross, but watch these defenders. They've got to fight through traffic. When you've got guys crossing, they've got to communicate. You see just the hesitation, just for a split second, allows Vitale to get a step on the defender, and by then it's too late. What you'll see on crossing routes. They're not very complicated. You're just trying to get those defenders to get in each other's way.
How important special teams and turnovers can be. That was the first down of the game. And the touchdown, only a 10-yard touchdown pass, was the longest offensive play of the game for Northwestern. And they've got the lead. After 4 straight 3 and outs, their 5th possession results in a 7-3 advantage. Here's Kenny Bell. Pretty good return. 27-yard line. Travion Henry made the tackle. Nebraska comes in at 4-2, 1-1 in the Big Ten. Of course, they lost at Ohio State 2 weeks ago, 63-38. The most points that Nebraska has allowed since the year before Bo Pelini arrived. They gave up 65 to Colorado back in 2007. So they are looking for a bounce back. Here's Taylor Martinez swinging one wide. Finds Kenny Bell. Now to the 34-yard line, a gain of 7. Now, I call Jets games on radio back in New York. To me, the Big Ten right now looks like the AFC East. I mean, who isn't in it, especially considering an amazing win by Ohio State over Purdue? Ohio State and Penn State, 2 of the 4 teams without a loss, they're ineligible to play in the Big Ten championship game.
It is wide open right now in the Big Ten.
Abdullah breaks a tackle. He's got a first down. And Amir Abdullah a little slow to get up. Rex Burkhead already leaving the game, in case you're just joining us, earlier in the first quarter with what looks to be a left knee injury. Amir Abdullah is a very capable backup, but the Huskers would like to have their main running back. Here's Taylor Martinez. Blockers out in front, hurdles his way for another Nebraska first down.
Wow, Taylor Martinez, the reason that play was successful was the guys he had leading for him just plowed Northwestern's defenders. Watch the guard, the center pulling, number 8, Abdullah. Those Northwestern defenders all on the ground made that a pretty easy run for Martinez.
Abdullah caught behind the line. May have fought his way for a yard. It looks to be good for a gain of 1 to the 46 of Northwestern. Araguzo and Deontay Gibson combining the tackle. We've got another injury. That's Jeremiah Searles, the right tackle. Looks to be holding his left ankle. Nebraska will roll a lot of different offensive linemen through their rotation. So Andrew Rodriguez, who is listed on their depth chart as an either-or starter at right tackle, he can swing back and forth. So it's a very deep offensive line group, but you don't want to lose one of the big guys up front. So Searles limps off.
Just look at number 71, Searles. You see the running back just runs right up into him. Then number 98 for Northwestern, Deontay Gibson, unintentionally just rolled up. And that's the danger you have as an offensive lineman. You know, there's nothing you can do about that play right there. There's just guys flying around your legs constantly. They try to wear those big braces. You see them on there. Sometimes you just get rolled up and you just hope for the best.
So that will take us down to the end of the first quarter. And it was an eventful first quarter. Only 30 yards of total offense in the first quarter for Northwestern. And they still have a 7-3 lead over Bo Pelini's Huskers. Plenty of Nebraska Cornhusker fans here. And they trail Northwestern 7-3 as we start the second quarter. Bible Shoes and Danny Cannell, Maria Taylor with you in Evanston, Illinois. Now, a lot was made this past week about the fact that if the Northwestern Wildcats came out a little bit sluggish, they would have no excuses because Pat Fitzgerald gave them some nap time.
Yes, he did. You know, football players are creatures of habit, and he felt like his team's daily schedule was such that they were always taking a nap around 3:30, which just so happened to be kickoff.
Play action for Taylor Martinez on first down. Whips one high to the sideline and is pulled in by Quincy Anunma for a gain of about 8. Well, he met with his leadership council after a recent 2:30 start when his team kind of came out sluggish. He said, guys, what's the problem? I said, well, normally, you know, we practice at 7 o'clock in the morning. In the afternoon, we take a nap. So that's what he did today. He gave them some nap time before the start of the game.
And I love the communication between Pat Fitzgerald and his team, trusting them, saying, hey, I'm going to listen to these guys. They give me this bit of advice. I'm going to go ahead and instill that cat nap on the schedule.
Martinez under pressure. Flips it down the sideline, and it's broken up. Wabusi sagging back, knocked it away. It will be third down and 3 as we go down to Maria.
Yeah, guys, an update on Rex Burkett. He's been walking around visibly really frustrated. I've seen him throw a couple of towels, but he's walking around the sideline with ice on that left knee. And also, guys, I did do a little bit of a sideline poll on nap time. 5 guys told me they actually took a nap when they were scheduled to before the game on Northwestern's sideline.
Well, maybe they'll start to wake up now as it was a sluggish start for the Northwestern offense. Pardon me, it's fourth down, obviously, as Maher's on to punt, and he will hoist it down. Kenny Bell keeps it out of the end zone.
Wow, beautiful job by Kenny Bell locating that ball, swatting it back to his return guys. We're able to down it.
Northwestern inside there on 5 when we come back.
So I'm sitting there talking to leadership council on Monday morning. I'm like, all right, so seriously, what's the deal? You know, why do we not start fast? And he looked at me like, well, coach, it's nap time. I'm like, what? And they go, that's the time we take a nap. So we'll be taking a nap at about, I don't know, 9:30 on Saturday morning to make sure we get our nap in so we're in our comfort zone and we feel good. So does ABC at 2:30 matter? No, our nap matters. It's unbelievable. I mean, seriously, that's what I get. This is what I get paid to do. You know what I mean? Seriously, create nap time. It's pathetic.
That's the head coach, Pat Fitzgerald, and he showed us the itinerary.
Yep.
Morning breakfast about 9:20. Mandatory nap time a half hour later. And as Maria Taylor told you, there were several Wildcats that took advantage of it. They're a little sluggish offensively to start, but they'll need to wake up now as it's first and 10 from their own 3-yard line. And with Mark. Might have lost a yard.
Benrick Mark, the ball carrier.
So Benrick Mark loses a yard. Now, we also decided to take Pat Fitzgerald's advice.
Yeah, I feel fresh.
Yeah, we didn't want to get off to a sluggish start today. So earlier today, our crew, we had nappy time.
This was mandatory, too. This was on our itinerary.
This, by the way, are not live shots, thank goodness. Yeah. And just in case you think Danny and I didn't want to make sure that we got a little bit of beauty rest as well. Yeah, we closed our eyes, too. Out close to the 5-yard line, Kane Coulter. and a heap of tacklers for a couple of yards. It'll be third down and 8 at the 5 for Northwestern. So, what, do you think that should be part of our weekly routine?
I feel fresh. I feel, you know, it's part of my schedule too now. So I think we have to keep it in there.
You look revitalized.
There you go. That's a big third down for Northwestern, backed up. Now they've got Coulter in there. This is not where he excels as a pocket passer.
From the goal line, swings it wide, and that is short of the first down. Catch made by Tony Jones. First pass attempt for Kane Coulter comes up at least 3 yards shy of the first down. As we take a look at our Pacific Life game summary, as Northwestern is set to punt again.
Well, it's been a little sloppy offensively for both teams. Other than Nebraska's first drive, both teams kind of feeling each other out. And of course, Rex Burkhead being out is the big storyline for Nebraska. How are they going to recover from that? But, you know, offensive coordinator for Northwestern, Mick McCall, he said this is going to be like a street fight, and that's pretty much what we're seeing.
This game has been all about field position so far. Kenny Bell calls for a fair catch and muffs the punt. Again, Northwestern's got it. Kenny Bell muffs a kick. Amir Abdullah set up the only touchdown we've had so far today when he dropped a punt. So Bo Pelini sees his team continue with self-inflicted wounds. That's the only reason they're losing.
Well, when we talked to Bo Pelini early in the week, he said special teams were a big concern. You wouldn't think you'd be concerned about Kenny Bell. He's such an important part to this team, usually shorthanded. And Nick Van Hoos, another one, second time he's recovered a muffed punt. But, I mean, Bo Pelini, to hear him talk about special teams, you know, you could just feel him starting to get heated. Said, we're going to make a lot of changes. They've changed some personnel up, and he has got to be concerned about his special teams unit.
Northwestern's 7th offensive possession. They've got Simeon back in. He wants a shot down the sideline to Tony Jones, and it's knocked away. Jones had a step on Jean-Baptiste.
Yes, he did.
And he was underthrown by Simeon.
He had a touchdown pass there, Trevor Simeon. And that was just a straight go route out on the sideline. There's Tony Jones. That ball is a little bit underthrown, which allowed Stanley Jean-Baptiste to catch up to that football. If that ball is out in front where Tony Jones can run under it and not slow down, that ball is 6 for Northwestern.
Simeon wants a throwback screen. High pass. Almost intercepted. With a flag down in the offensive backfield as well. P.J. Smith should have picked that ball off. This will most likely be holding, and it will, against Northwestern. But that should have been a turnover going back in the other direction.
Well, a couple of these throws by some of the quarterbacks playing today on both sides of the ball. Some questionable decisions. That time it was Trevor Simeon. Now, you've got a screen called. He's trying to get it to his guy. But that ball floated in the air for what seemed like an eternity.
Holding number 75, offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat, second down.
That calls on Jack Kanapka. He was a tight end last year. Now he's starting at right tackle this year. Well, Northwestern only has 1 first down.
Right.
Still good for the lead.
And look at their touchdown was when they had the ball with incredible field position off the turnover. Other than that, they have not been able to generate any kind of momentum.
Four-man rush. Simeon down the sideline looking for Jones again. It'll be third down now, at 20. Again, Jean-Baptiste there in coverage.
Now, what Northwestern is trying to do, they're trying to get the defensive backs for Nebraska to back off of them. They're playing press man coverage across the board. They're getting in the wide receivers' faces. So in order to open up the short passing game, you've got to try to back them off. Show them that you can throw the deep ball, but they're having no success with it. Here's a press. There's a press. They're up there challenging.
Even on third and 20, and Northwestern will play the punt. Then Rick Mark picks up 3.5, maybe 4 yards. So the Wildcats will kick it away.
Aflac.
Time now for our Aflac trivia question. Who was the president the last time Nebraska played at Northwestern?
Ooh, that's a good one.
It's been a while.
That is.
Since the Huskers were in Evanston.
If I give the year, does it give it away?
Well, to anyone with a cell phone, it would. Anyone that has access to Google. And a mock cheer from all the Husker fans as Amir Abdullah makes a successful fair catch. The Husker fans love it. They held on to a putt.
Loudest cheer of the day.
ESPN's College Football on ABC. Brought to you by Goodyear. Chosen for superior performance. Goodyear. More driven. And Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live Mas.
The Deering Library at Northwestern, built in 1932. Features 68 stained glass windows. And that's a live shot. It actually features two Northwestern students that have skipped the game today. So their parents can be proud. As the rest of us aren't studying at all. Back to the offense for Nebraska at their own 39-yard line. Amir Abdullah still in the game as the primary tailback next to Taylor Martinez.
Nebraska's been utilizing the play-action pass on first down quite a bit.
A straight run for Martinez.
Taylor Martinez.
Flag down on the far side of the field. David Wabusi pushed him out, but this will be, it looks like, a penalty against the Huskers. See if Pat Fitzgerald takes the down or the penalty. It was only maybe a half-yard gain on first down.
Illegal formation. Number 63 was not on the line of scrimmage. We had five in the backfield. Five-yard penalty. Repeat. First down.
So rather than taking the down, Pat Fitzgerald takes the penalty, so it's first and 15. Getting to the edge is Abdullah. Hit from behind, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
Bob, what's your clue?
Time now for the answer to our Aflac trivia question. The president, the last time Nebraska played at Northwestern. Well, it's been a while. Herbert Hoover back in 1931. Second down and four. The late pitch from Martinez to Abdullah. And Amir Abdullah all the way to the 42-yard line of Northwestern with a first down for Nebraska. Now, it has been a while since Nebraska was here. So long, in fact, that the last time they played here, that was the celebrity guest. Al Capone, believe it or not, attended that game and got booed by the crowd as he would go.
I wouldn't have booed him.
Well, at that point, I think, according to the stories, he wasn't quite as intimidating considering the fact that they all knew he was going to be going to prison soon. High throw right up the seam and a completion. Kyler Reed, did he lose the football? He did. Another turnover by Nebraska on what should have been a big play. Kyler Reed coughs it up. And Northwestern has it back. Jared Carpenter recovers the fumble.
Wow, I'm surprised Bo Pelini is keeping his cool on the sideline. Yet another costly play for Nebraska. There's Kyler Reed. Makes a nice catch over the middle of the ball. Then trying to get those extra yards. Takes the one hand off the ball to stiff arm. And that other hand, just one hand on the football. Pretty nice job by Ibrahim Campbell swatting that ball out of there to create that turnover. Look at that. Three turnovers on the day for Nebraska.
And that puts Nebraska now at minus nine on the season overall in the giveaway takeaway. And Rick Mark, a gain of a yard and a half as we go back to Robert Flores. All right, Robert, thanks very much. A huge win on the road for LSU as they survive at Texas A&M. And that's Thad Randall shaking up on that last play for Nebraska. And he is limping off as well, favoring that braced right knee.
It's been a tough day for Nebraska, not only the turnovers, but Rex Burkhead was down. They had their tackle, Jeremiah Searles, down. Now you're losing another defensive player. This going to be one of those physical afternoons for Nebraska, for both teams.
Looks like six defensive backs on the field for Nebraska, with Simeon back in at quarterback. A little check down underneath, incomplete. Over the head of Venrick Mark, but a flag thrown in the secondary. So a sloppy game continues to get sloppier. We'll have to check the flag. Offensive pass interference.
That time, Northwestern, much like they scored in the touchdown, tried to run some crossing routes, but that time they got caught picking off a defender. I think they were a little too blatant with what they were trying to do. So you can call it a rub, you can call it a pick, a mesh.
Pass interference, number two of the offense. Half the distance to the goal. Repeat, second down.
That's Kane Coulter. Called for the pick.
Here's a look. The receiver's coming across. And then he knows what he's supposed to do. He's supposed to try to rub the defenders. But look at where he goes and just basically blocks before that ball has been caught.
A lob down the sideline, knocked away. That was textbook coverage by Stanley Jean-Baptiste on Kyle Prater.
Once again, Nebraska just getting up in the face of these Northwestern receivers, daring Trevor Siemian and company to beat them over the top. And that's about 0 for 3 or 4 on the fade route that they just have not been able to connect. And until they're able to burn them deep, Nebraska's going to keep doing it all day long.
Northwestern 1 for 7 on third down. This is third and 20. They've got 43 yards of total offense. Denrick Mark picks up 4. They're averaging 1.9 yards per offensive play, and they've got a 7-3 lead.
All off of the turnover when they had the ball in great field position, were able to punch that in. Other than that drive, it's been sluggish.
So 3 in the turnover ratio, have a chance to get the ball in plus territory possibly here. Fair catch called for and made by Abdullah. That draws another standing ovation from the Big Red fans. We'll step aside. Ryan Field sold out today, but it has as much to do with the fans in red as the fans in purple. Tons of Nebraska fans. Obviously, many of Nebraska alums call Chicago home, but certainly a lot have made the trip here as well. Great field position for the Huskers, and a trap handoff to Abdullah. Close to a first down. Gains 8.5 yards. Ibrahim Campbell made the stop. It'll be second down and short for what has been a sloppy first half. Bob Wischusen, Danny Cannell, and Maria Taylor in a game that one way or the other is going to shift things in the Legends division of the Big Ten.
Without question. And yeah, this is very much a defensive battle so far, with some offenses struggling through the air and on the ground. Really, both right now showing to be too one-dimensional.
Martinez slings it over the middle to Kenny Bell. Can he get a block? At the goal line! Touchdown!
Taylor Martinez pass is complete to
Something had to give. Watch a little double post route off of play action. Taylor Martinez, you see him stick the ball in the belly. Linebackers come up. The first guy's not there. Martinez finds the wide open receiver down the middle of the field and a nice read. You almost felt like something had to give. Somebody had to step up and make a play. And Nebraska draws first blood.
Kenny Bell led the Huskers in yards and touchdown receptions last season, leads them in yards and touchdown receptions this season. 5th touchdown catch of the year for Kenny Bell, and that's 13 touchdown passes against only 4 interceptions for Taylor Martinez as Nebraska takes the lead.
Welcome back. Nebraska just scoring their first touchdown of the game. Right after Martinez throws the touchdown, the first person he sees is Joe Gans, the GA for the offense, and he tells him that's what happens when you don't predetermine your reads. He was excited to see the GA that he really trusts with his game, guys.
Well, Maria, Joe Gans, old quarterback for Nebraska, but Danny Cannell, when you look at the progress that Taylor Martinez has made, what do you see?
That was a big point of contention for them, was getting his mechanics straightened out. And when talking to offensive coordinator, he said, hey, we had to push the refresh button. We had to start over from scratch.
That might be what Northwestern needs for their offense. It'll come out to the 25 on the kneel down by Hanrahan. And this week, ABC Saturday Night Football, most of the nation will see ACC rivals clash. The old-time Florida rivalry between the Seminoles and the Hurricanes. And then others of you will see Baylor take on number 25, Texas. The Longhorns and Bears will battle Saturday Night Football, presented by Windows 8. Florida State, Miami, Baylor, Texas tonight at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC.
There's a look at Joe Gans talking to Taylor Martinez. And it's great to have a guy who played the position, knows what the pressure's like, knows what it's like to be back in that backfield.
Kane Coulter reverses field. And picks up about 9 on first down. A nice cutback run by Kane Coulter. P.J. Smith tripped him up.
He's the guy that's got to get something started. He's the spark plug for Northwestern, no matter if he's in the backfield as the quarterback or if he's at wideout. They need to find creative ways to get him in the open field against Nebraska.
Northwestern looking for their second first down, and it won't come on this play. Second down and a half yard, and Venrick Mark gets shoved back. Now it'll be third down and a half yard. Baker Steinkuhler made the stop as we take a look at some of our game trends. In Nebraska, they're basically -4 in the turnover ratio. They drop an interception. They've got 3 turnovers as well. Almost -5 as they committed a personal foul on what should have been a muff punt fumble recovery also. And they're winning. Kane Coulter, does he move the chains on third down the foot? It looks like he just does squeeze it across the 35-yard line. And that is the second first down for Northwestern.
Well, Northwestern's getting back to what kind of their identity. That's run the football on the ground. They've been trying to take some shots to take advantage of the press coverage outside, but it's not working.
Coulter dragged down for a loss of 2. David Santos track down Coulter. It'll be second down and 12.
Nebraska obviously watched a lot of game tape of Kane Coulter running that option attack because they are staying so fundamentally sound. They've had a bye week. I think that's a key part of this game, too. You've got to remember, they've been using their scout team to give them every look they were going to see from Kane Coulter, and they look very well prepared.
So now it's Simeon back to the quarterback. And a counter handoff to Mike Trumpy. That gained a yard. Now it'll be third down and 11.
That's the other thing Nebraska's been able to do is really put Northwestern in poor third down situations. Third and long, you've seen quite a few of those. Here's a third and 11 because they were able to stuff that run, or they've been able to stuff the run or prevent Northwestern from connecting on those deeper balls. Once again, though, challenging these guys on the outside all the way across the board.
Third down and nearly 10 yards on each third down for Northwestern. They'll take another shot down the sideline. Underthrown but incomplete. Rashad Lawrence blanketed. And it will be fourth down.
Well, sooner or later, something's going to give. Nebraska is doing a phenomenal job of running toe-for-toe with the Northwestern wideouts. But sooner or later, Northwestern's got to mix in a comeback, maybe a back shoulder throw, because going over the top is not working.
Simeon's one for his last 7. And it has been a busy first half for Brandon Williams.
Those are low percentage throws, those fade routes down the sideline, and it's showing up.
Trying to keep it away from Abdullah. And this will take a hop sideways and go out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. So it goes back to Nebraska with the field goal lead. And with the trophy still up for grabs, the second half of the chase heads to Kansas. Brett Keselowski, Jimmy Johnson, Denny Hamlin are 1, 2, 3, but Clint Boyer has now jumped up to 4th. With only 5 races left, it's Kansas next. The NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Kansas, presented by Dodge, tomorrow on ESPN at 1 p.m. Jeremiah Searles is back in at right tackle for Nebraska. And a little toss. This might be a reverse, and it is. Here's Kenny Bell. That's a long way to go to pick up a half yard. Ibrahim Campbell stayed home and made the stop on Bell.
That's the problem I have with some of these reverses that you run. You lose so much ground to set it up that by the time you get back to line of scrimmage, everybody else has had time to recognize and catch up to the play. And that's exactly what happened there.
Opelini's offense still playing without Rex Burkhead, left with a knee injury back in the first quarter. Taylor Martinez breaks a tackle. He's about a yard and a half shy of a first down. It will be third down and short. Damian Proby, the leading tackler for Northwestern, made the stop.
On a good decision with the football there by Taylor Martinez to keep it himself. He runs that zone read quite a bit as well and does it so effectively. He's such a great runner on the ground and has really improved as a passer this season.
Nebraska 1-for-5 on third down. They'll try and throw for it. Martinez, a little dump across the body to Abdullah, and he's well short. Proby stayed with Amir Abdullah, and it will be fourth down, and Northwestern will get the football back.
Got a big stand for Northwestern. Their defense is going to have to kind of carry over their offense until their offense can make some adjustments to try to move the football.
Now it's Venrick Mark back to receive the punt. Northwestern averages about 408 yards of offense per game. They've got 57 yards of offense in the first half, and yet they're only down by three. And a shanked punt is going to go out of bounds. Might be near midfield by the time it is right at midfield where Northwestern will take over.
Great field position. The last time they had great field position, they were able to capitalize.
A 16-yard punt by Brett Maher as we take a look at this week's BCS standings brought to you by Tostitos. And I know Danny Cannell, when he saw the BCS standings officially come out for the first time last week, with that ACC bias and bitterness coming through, not a fan of the fact that Oregon got knocked back to third.
I think Oregon made a pretty clear statement, too, on Thursday night with a big win against Arizona State. It'll all work itself out, though. That's where we can all relax, including myself.
First and 10 at midfield. Simeon with a bullet throw and a connection. Only a 4-yard gain to Rashad Lawrence. It'll be second down and 6.
Northwestern trying to go up there with a little no huddle. The thing you're doing there is you're trying to get those DBs to back off, and yet here they come.
4-man rush. Simeon slings it to the sideline. Short of the first down by 2 yards. Kyle Prater steps out at the Nebraska 42, so it will be third down and 2.
And I like Mick McCall, the offensive coordinator for Northwestern, giving Trevor Simeon some easier balls, some higher percentage throws, kind of build his confidence to set up the deep shots.
Here comes a blitz on third down. Venrick Mark right at the first down marker. Where will they spot the football? He might be shy.
I think he is going to be short. I don't think it was the best spot for Northwestern just from up here seeing that where the official spotted it. And Northwestern is going to go for this. Yeah, you might want to take a look at the spot here.
Well, Northwestern will talk things over.
Is that the runner was short of the line to gain. Fourth down, the play is under further review.
So we'll step aside. Oh, check that. We're going to stay right here with 3:03 to go before halftime. They will review the spot and see whether or not Venrick Mark did get to the 40-yard line or not. It didn't look like the most generous spot. It's a full half yard shy. They didn't even need to bring the chains out to measure.
No, with the call that they had.
Well, this is the play before when Kyle Prater stepped out about 2 yards shy. And then here's third down and 2. Here's Venrick Mark.
And from where he fell forward, I mean, look, those are his legs right there. I mean, I think that ball has some room to be over the line. I mean, he's got to be.
Here's the problem, though. If you can't see the football, there has to be indisputable evidence that the football got to the 40-yard line. And if you can't see the ball, even if you're right, all logic states that the ball got to the 40-yard line, can you adjust this spot?
That's a critical play in this game, too. With 3 minutes before half, Northwestern. To get a whole new set of downs here, to get that first down, that's a huge difference in having the pressure of having to convert this.
Let's see if we get a better look at where the ball is in relation to the 40-yard line, which is the stripe in the middle of your screen.
There's Ben McMahon coming down.
Well, clearly his right shoulder is on the line. His helmet is across the line. Where's the football? You still can't see the football with that look. Now, as we said, all logic states he's got the ball in his right arm.
Right.
If his right arm is attached to his right shoulder and his right shoulder is across the line. Well, here's the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. He's short of the line to gain, fourth down.
Ruling on the field stands is different than ruling on the field is confirmed. When the official says the ruling on the field stands, that tells you that the video evidence was not indisputable. So now it is fourth down and a half yard, and Northwestern will line up to go for it with Kane Coulter under center. Will they snap the ball?
Yeah, I think they've got a play here. They just kind of wanted to see what Nebraska was going to do.
Coulter with a quarterback snap. And he's got a couple of yards.
No doubt that they had the first down on that one. Good surge by the offensive line. Now they've got the new set of downs that they've got. Now Simeon's back in there at quarterback, who was moving the ball from that no huddle. But again, look at all the presses across the board.
Again, a four-man rush. Simeon, that ball batted down at the line. Looked like Joseph Carter got a hand up to knock it down. Let's check in with Robert Flores. We've got a tight one here, 10-7. Nebraska on top of Northwestern. The Wildcats in plus territory. They only have three first downs here in the first half. Simeon over the middle. That's well short of the first down. Finding Christian Jones on a little square into the 33.
Well, Nebraska's doing an outstanding job of not giving Northwestern many easy completions. Even that one there was tightly contested. Trevor Simeon had to thread the needle to Christian Jones.
Ciante Evans brought down Christian Jones 5 yards shy of the first down. So it's another third down and medium, third and five. They're trying to run for it with Mark. And the pile moves close to the first down marker. It looks like he's got it. How about that surge by the Wildcat offensive line and Venrick Mark?
How about the effort, the second effort from Venrick Mark? I mean, that ball, he was well short of the first down, and then that's the second effort. And he's not the biggest guy. He's 5'8", 175 pounds. But he runs big.
The first drive of the game where Northwestern has more than one first down. Simeon again fades one down the sideline for Tony Jones. He's got it. Touchdown.
Well, it wasn't the first, second, or third. It was the sixth time was the charm on the fade route. Tony Jones able to get a step, and Simeon's able to place that ball perfectly. Finally, Northwestern able to capitalize.
Second touchdown pass of the first half for Trevor Simeon. He found Dan Vitale in the first quarter. He finds Tony Jones here before halftime. And taking the lead, the Northwestern Wildcats. They only have 107 yards of total offense, and they're on top on the scoreboard. Just a beautiful day for football here at Northwestern. Picture perfect fall afternoon. The colors just outside of Chicago in full bloom, as Northwestern now has a 14-10 lead over Nebraska. But there is, as you can see, plenty of red in town. Probably about a 50-50 split in terms of the fans that are here red and purple, Trevor Siemian. 4-5 with a touchdown pass on that last
one. Notice how it started off, too. Shorter throws, build up his confidence, and was able to connect on the last one.
Short kickoff. Kenny Bell from the 10. Stays on his feet. Up to about the 22-yard line. So now Nebraska with a minute 19 to go in the first half and all three of their timeouts. Certainly plenty of time with the clock stopping. After you pick up a first down as well to get in position to possibly score some points before halftime.
Now an opportunity for Taylor Martinez to showcase his skills from the pocket. Of course, he's always dangerous as a running threat, but in this situation, you'd expect him to be a little bit more of a pocket passer.
Quarterback draw. And Martinez only able to get the drive started with a 2-yard gain, stood up by David Wabusi.
Boy, David Wabusi did a great job recognizing that that was a straight QB draw that time. Was able to fill up that hole and come stuff Martinez rather quickly.
Only a 1-yard gain on first down. It's been a terrific career for Wabusi here at Northwestern. Martinez bullets one right up the seam. He finds Jamal Turner, and Turner gets free close to midfield.
A nice throw by Martinez, set his back foot in the ground, delivered the perfect pass, and now they've got to start hustling a little bit more of a sense of urgency. 41 seconds.
Nebraska still with all of their timeouts. Yep. And now it looks like Pat Fitzgerald might have called a timeout from the Northwestern sideline.
Timeout. Northwestern, first charge, timeout, 30 seconds.
So Pat Fitzgerald wants to bring his defense over with 34 seconds to go here before halftime. This is a game that really could change both of these two team seasons radically, depending on the outcome, and affect the divisional race in their half of the Big Ten. We talked about the standings when we came on the air and the fact that you've got two teams still without a loss. A great win today for Ohio State coming from behind to force overtime and beat Purdue. And then Penn State also undefeated at this point. But both of those two teams, Danny, are ineligible to play in the Big Ten championship game. So it's such a wide open race with all of the other teams in the mix. And these are two one-loss teams that have every reason to believe, the winner certainly today, that they are in the race to maybe get to Indy. Martinez, long throw across the field. He's got Jamal Turner again. And Turner brought down inbounds. And now Nebraska will have to spend one of their timeouts with 24 seconds to go in the first half.
They've got plenty of them. That's what allowed Turner to kind of make that move to the inside. When you've got all those timeouts, that luxury, you can work the middle of the field. You can throw that ball and try to catch that defense widening out towards the sideline and take a shot. Or work a back with a simple check down. Sometimes those guys can pick up a lot of yards on the ground. You just get up there and call a quick timeout. I'm surprised they didn't call a timeout, though, before their first completed pass. There was about 7 or 8 seconds that I felt like was kind of wasted on the clock, and they become so critical in this situation.
Well, Pat Fitzgerald managed the clock there well. He wanted to call a timeout to make sure that his defense was set, but he waited until the ball had been set for play, waited until the clock started to wind, and just as Nebraska was about to snap it, that's when he called his timeout. Take as much time off the clock as possible. And it certainly limits what the Huskers can do now. 24 seconds to go in the first half. Martinez under pressure and sacked back at the 45-yard line. And Bo Pelini will spend timeout number two with only 16 seconds to go in the first half.
Brian Arnfeldt, just relentless pursuit of the quarterback on that one. And Taylor Martinez was trying to take a shot down the field, too. Arnfeldt splits the two Nebraska linemen and then able to finally finish off the sack at the end. And that is going to be a huge sack right there, because that's going to make it that much harder for Nebraska to get in the field goal range.
Well, the Huskers now facing third down and 13 on their own side of the 50-yard line. They only have one timeout left. Now, they have a terrific kicker in Brett Maher if they can get him in position.
I would be surprised if they run a run play here and try to eliminate disaster and just take it, play it safe and head into the locker room.
Maher's long on the year is 54 yards. So he's got a strong leg. Can Martinez get him in range? And now another timeout will be called. This time it'll be Pat Fitzgerald.
Once again,
timeout. Northwestern, timeout, 30 seconds.
I think you're right there, Shu. That's a little bit of gamesmanship. Pat Fitzgerald waited till the very last second, right before the snap, trying to kind of get a read off the offensive lineman, see what he was anticipating there so that he can get the correct defense in place.
So the chess match continues between Bo Pelini and Pat Fitzgerald. And talking to Pat Fitzgerald about his team, the chemistry they have, it was really interesting. It is a young team, and it's a team that we thought of as being a together group last year. But he said this year, their chemistry is more their identity than it's been ever before.
I think it's a reflection, too, of him as a coach, too, because he does a lot of things to develop that camaraderie. You know, even the little things like nap time, they're kind of fun, and they're funny. The whole nation kind of talked about it. But he has a lot of energy. You can tell he played here. He's passionate about the game and his team.
Only a three-man rush. Taylor Martinez comes underneath, finds Abdullah, who stumbles at the 46-yard line. And the last timeout here in the first half for Nebraska called by Bo Pelini. So will Maher try one? You're talking from here probably about a 63 or 64-yard field goal, or do you just ask Taylor Martinez to throw it as far as he can?
Well, that's a conversation you got to have with Maher before the game. You know, in warm-ups, you're out there talking to him, you know, saying, hey, what's your comfort zone?
Here's one thing to consider. If he misses and the play doesn't take 10 seconds, you're going to give Northwestern possibly an offensive snap, you know, where they could easily throw one in the end zone. It looks like he's going to send Maher out there. So Bo Pelini is going to try a long field goal. Well, obviously, Maher's also the punter, so on fourth down, this could as easily be Maher punting the ball as trying a field goal. And they're not sending the holder out. They're just going to have him punt it away. Northwestern has no return men back deep, as they are simply guarding against any type of a trick play. And Maher will let it go. That will roll down at the 1 yard line. And inexplicably, with the ball dead on the 1 yard line, it looks as if.
But he's down at the 1 yard line, and that concludes the first half.
The ball that will win the first half.
Wow. I was thinking the same thing as you.
Let's go down to Maria.
Yeah, Coach. Three turnovers in the first half. How do you get it back on track offensively, eliminate those errors?
Well, two of them run special teams, obviously, and then, you know, we got to eliminate that. We're lucky to be in the game. Playing well defensively, we got to get our act together.
All right. And what do you think about Martinez's play in the first half?
He did some good things. He's got some things he's got to fix for the second half.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
All right, Maria. Bo Pelini not pleased, as his team is -3 in the plus-minus ratio. And they are behind on the scoreboard as well. The halftime report coming up next with Northwestern on top by 4. Spectacular day for football here at Northwestern. And back in Evanston, set for the start of the third quarter, Bob Wischusen, Danny Cannell, Maria Taylor. It's a tight one between Northwestern and Nebraska. Nebraska won the toss, deferred their option to the second half, so the Huskers will start the second half with the ball. Great atmosphere, sold out crowd, at least in part due to the fact that you can see a couple of people in red found their way to Evanston.
Quite a bit of representation on behalf of the Cornhuskers.
Northwestern was +3 in turnovers in the first half, and they used that to take the 14-10 lead. Only 107 yards of total offense. Here's Kenny Bell from the goal line. A little cut back, and he barely squeezes past the 15-yard line as we take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. And Northwestern with two touchdown passes, Danny, thrown by Trevor Siemian.
Trevor Siemian, once he was finally able to calm down a little bit, the first one on a simple crossing route, early in the first quarter, able to capitalize off the turnover, and then later, finally, able to connect on a fade route down the sideline. And that'll be something to watch for. Will Nebraska keep challenging those Northwestern wide receivers throughout the second half?
Taylor Martinez with Amir Abdullah to his left. On a keeper himself, and he's got room. Taylor Martinez sidesteps a tackler all the way out to about the 29-yard line. And not only is it Danny and myself, but we also found one of our other guys that found his way back here to his old stomping grounds. Michael Wilbon, you see him on PTI on NBA Countdown. He was
not
out
like
there
this,
tossing
though,
the coin.
You know, it's a little bit different.
Hey, you got up. You're an alum. You got to wear your colors.
I'm happy to wear them. There's a lot of red out here. We got some purple, but I'd like to see more.
The guest captain today is Amir Abdullah. Uses the stiff arm, gets out to the 40-yard line out there to toss the coin. Northwestern football, Pat Fitzgerald, where he has the program right now as an alum, in your opinion?
Well, I mean, he's got it beyond expectations of the community. Not beyond his own expectations. He was All-American here, two-time All-American, Defensive Player of the Year in the Big Ten, led his team to a Rose Bowl. He expects this and beyond. And he's got recruiting improved. Every single thing improved as we watch Taylor Martinez here.
Want to run the option, a little shovel pitch late to Abdullah, and that was well stretched by the front seven for Northwestern, a gain of only about a yard and a half.
Now, you're pretty involved with the program here at Northwestern, come to some practices in the offseason. Who are some of the players on their squad that impress you?
Well, you know, people are just finding out, Danny, about Venrick Mark, and people here knew, and I think people who scout in the professional business who get around the campuses knew, and this kid, he's not having a lot of space today with this Nebraska defense, but he's been very impressive so far in the Big Ten season.
Martinez can't hook up with Quincy Anunwa, so it will be third. You said you were down in the field before the game, watching Nebraska, the physical difference potentially between the Huskers and the Wildcats, and where we're at right now.
Size and speed. And that's what Northwestern's trying to get to, and Pat Fitzgerald hopes to. But the combination of size and speed, I mean, Nebraska's got that over almost anybody and everybody except some of the SEC schools, but it's amazing to watch them that close and in person.
Huskers are 1-for-7 on third down. Only a three-man rush. Martinez with plenty of time, but that is short of the first down again.
Is this an area where they go for it?
Found Tim Marlowe just shy of the 50-yard line. Would you go for it on fourth down and a yard and a half from your own side of the 50?
Not in this situation, the way the game has unfolded so far. I saw a couple of the right tackle, Jeremiah Searles, wanted to go for it, trying to plead with Bo Pelini, give us a shot. But at this point in the game, the way the game is played, too, it's been kind of ugly. Teams feeling each other out. I think you try to play a little bit of field position here and pin Northwestern back.
So Maher kicks it away. A line drive. Venrick Mark waves his teammates away, and it will go out of bounds inside the 10-yard line. At about the 7. So we'll step aside. Michael Wilbon, thanks for
Thank
a few moments. We appreciate
me.
It.
Appreciate it.
The honorary captain for his Northwestern Wildcats today. They've got a 4-point lead.
Welcome back to Ryan Field, where I had the chance to catch up with Northwestern's head coach, Pat Fitzgerald, before the start of the second half. He said two things need to happen offensively. Number one, they have to take advantage of the one-on-one battles and continue to get their athletes in space. Also, he says when there are turnovers committed by Nebraska, they have to do a better job of capitalizing.
All right, Maria, well, Northwestern gets the football back, but field position not on their side as Venrick Mark gets out of bounds. At about the 11-yard line, a gain of 4. We go back to Robert Flores. Robert is 14-10 here as Rashad Lawrence is able to knife his way for a first down on a little square in from Trevor Siemian. Mohamed Cisse made the stop. Danny, as we take a look at the first half numbers and certainly the three turnovers for Nebraska, the biggest reason why it's a 4-point lead for the Wildcats.
Without question, you saw the frustration on Bo Pelini's face at halftime, too.
Off the fingertips of Christian Jones, probably should have had it for what would have been another Northwestern first down.
I think it was a great point that Maria got from Pat Fitzgerald, you know, talking to him at halftime, saying, hey, we're being challenged athletically. I mean, we need to get our guys in space, and they need to make plays for us, because right now Nebraska, what they're doing, the way we keep talking about them pressing the wide receivers on the outside, that's basically challenging them, saying, hey, we don't think that you can beat us, that you can get by us. They did it once with Christian Jones. Now the question is, can they do it again?
Whatever Nebraska's defensive call is, where Gallagher's got the sledgehammer, I would just go with that. To me, that's an automatic winner. Second and 10. Trap handoff up the middle, and it breaks for Venrick Mark. Can he be caught? He's gone. Touchdown. It has been a frustrating afternoon for the Cornhusker fans. Self-inflicted wounds, and finally, Northwestern breaks a big play offensively. The Wildcats had 120 yards of total offense before that run. That was an 80-yard touchdown run for Venrick Mark. And that stretches the lead to two scores.
How about this block right here, block out, and then watch this linebacker. Watch where he flies outside. All you have to do... Venrick Mark, that is as big a hole as you will find. Will Compton, obviously focused on King Coulter, went after the quarterback.
21-10, the Wildcats on top.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by Pacific Life. For insurance, annuities, and investments, choose Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed. And Nissan. Innovation for today, innovation for tomorrow, innovation that excites.
We went deep in the Northwestern archives, found a 1912 helmet you saw a moment before. That's a playbook from 1962. That just happens to be the last year that Northwestern was ranked number one in football. And how times have changed. Those helmets were given to the players right before the game started today, as they have gone basically all black with a little bit of their school purple on their jerseys.
I like them. Hey, there was a lot of talk about those on Twitter, too.
The players like them. That's certainly why the coaches do it. Short kick down to Kenny Bell at the 15-yard line. And Bell might break it. There goes Kenny Bell down the sideline, a flag down. Back at the 25-yard line. The kicker, Steve Flaherty, pushed Kenny Bell out at the Northwestern 40. We'll have to check the penalty.
During the return, holding number 89 of the return team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
So that will come back. An 80-yard touchdown run a moment ago by Venrick Mark. He's on the sideline, but yesterday we were in Cannell's classroom with Kane Coulter talking about that very play.
We're going to read this outside linebacker right here. And if he gets nosy in the box, instead of blocking, these two receivers are going to throw a little now screen, and I'm going to throw them the ball. If he stays outside, I'm going to hand it and let Venrick do the work.
There you go. You see the Sam winds out. Give it to Venrick. Huge play in the game last week versus Minnesota. Good decision, Kane. He does it all the time.
That was a huge decision by Kane Coulter to... give it to Venrick Mark a moment ago as Amir Abdullah gets to the edge, and he's all the way out to about the 30-yard line for a Nebraska first down. But I guess we'll take another look at the touchdown a moment ago, and you can tell us if it was the same read on that Sam linebacker for Kane Coulter as Venrick Mark sprung for the touchdown to make it 21-10. Taylor Martinez, play action fake, under pressure, throws a bullet that's dropped. Jamal Turner couldn't haul it in. Let's go back to the touchdown.
Here's one more look, and this time you'll actually see this linebacker right here. Watch him fly out. That's the one who's widening this time. And you'll see Kane Coulter hand it off, and then look at all that space he's got to run to. Venrick Mark lets his speed take over, and much like the play against Minnesota, split the very middle of the defense.
Second down and 10. Getting to the edge and stepping out of bounds. The first carry of the day for Braylon Hurd. That's a first down as Nebraska starts to step up their run game. Remember, this is the number one rush offense of the Big Ten, number five in the country.
Both of these teams made a couple adjustments at halftime and exposing some flaws in the defenses. First time we saw the middle of that Nebraska defense. This time, Nebraska exposing some of Northwestern's weaknesses.
Taylor Martinez, straight keeper. And he gets bumped in midfield and driven back after a gain of two. Damian Proby stepped up to fill from his Mike linebacker position for Northwestern. It will be second down and eight. It's been all Taylor Martinez and Amir Abdullah for the most part as the ball carriers for Nebraska. Back in the first quarter, Rex Burkhead lost for the rest of today, certainly, as he is in street clothes over on the sideline now. Ice on the left knee. He, of course, missed a couple of games after injuring his knee in the opener. He suffers another knee injury today. So Amir Abdullah has been the workhorse along with Martinez as the play clock's down to two. Play clock at one. Do they get the snap off? They did. Quarterback draw for Martinez. Breaks a tackle. Taylor Martinez with another first down. All the way down to the 35-yard line before he's pushed out.
Designed quarterback, almost like a quarterback sweep there to the left side. You let Amir Abdullah lead the way for you. And Taylor Martinez with the athleticism, the ability to utilize his skill set. He is tough to defend. I'll tell you what, he can do that much, and he's made such improvements in the passing game, too.
Abdullah lost a couple of yards. Forward progress to the 36, so it's a loss of only one. Second down and 11. David Babusi made the stop. Let's take a look at the numbers season-wide for this Nebraska offense and where they're at today.
Well, not quite. Obviously, they're not exactly where they want to be in this game. Still a whole half to play left, but I think scoring is the biggest. And they've shot themselves in the foot with the turnovers.
Abdullah's wide open. Instead, Martinez goes for the home run ball. At the 5-yard line, it's broken up. Quincy Enunwa had it in his hands and couldn't pull it in. Daniel Jones was there in coverage, but that looked like a drop, and Enunwa was shaken up.
Look at Enunwa at the end of that play. Ball's just a hair behind him. Almost comes down with it. Pretty good defensive play there by Daniel Jones. Just lands a little bit awkwardly, and it's good to see him up and running off the field now. Almost made the circus catch. Tell you what, if Daniel Jones hadn't got in there and batted that ball away, I think Enunwa would have made that catch.
So as Enunwa heads to the sideline, second leading receiver for Nebraska off the field, and it's third down and 10.
And this is an area where Taylor Martinez, I think, is a different quarterback now. I mean, this is going to be a straight dropback type of situation. He's been making better decisions, except for one game this year, and that was the last one against Ohio State. And even here, you don't have to get the entire first down. You might even think about going for it in two-down territory at this point in the field. So no reason to force this ball down the field.
Martinez will run. Turns the corner. Tripped up from behind. Tracked down by Wabusi. And it will be fourth down and three, and now they're in exactly the down and distance you just talked about, inside the 30-yard line. Do you try a long field goal, or do you go for it on fourth down at the 28?
Well, they're keeping the offense on the field right here. Again, it's a conversation you have with your kicker before the game. Where are you comfortable? If he says this is out of my range, I think you go for it all day long.
And also the conversation between Bo Pelini and the offensive coordinator, Tim Beck. Do you have the gotta-have-it play call here?
I think you get Taylor Martinez out of the pocket, let him with a little run-pass option.
Still time on the play clock. Fourth down and three. Martinez heads in the wrong direction. Northwestern gets the stop on downs. Dean Lowry. He keyed Martinez from the start.
Well, they ran the same exact play they ran on third and 10. And Dean Lowry just shot the gap, showed up in Taylor Martinez's face almost instantly, really had no chance to get that. Right here, just watch him shoot the gap. He comes up, nobody blocks him there.
Tyler Reed, the tight end, ran into his own man. You wonder if there was a blocking schematic problem there for Nebraska. Beautiful looks at downtown Chicago, just outside of Chicago here at Northwestern. We're not in Lincoln. And as you see, a lot of red in the stands here at Ryan Field, but the folks in red quiet as Northwestern back to the offense. Venrick Mark picks up about 3 yards. Let's go back to that fourth down play, though, a moment ago, Danny, and and the missed blocking assignment.
Definitely miscommunication. Watch where the tight end goes. All the action's going this way, but watch where he goes. Runs into a tackle right next to him. Well, the guard, the pulling guard. You know, we gave Dean Lowry a lot of credit. He did make the play, but I think you might have been able to make that play, Bob.
Under some pressure is Simeon. And he'll throw it away. Being chased by Jason Ankara. So now it's third down and seven for Northwestern. Northwestern only had 57 yards of total offense on their first nine drives. Their last two drives, 143 yards and two touchdowns. So yep. They've really turned things around offensively, but now in danger of another three and out.
There are a lot of opportunities out there on the field for Northwestern to make.
Simeon, deep comeback route to the near sideline, and here comes the flag. Rashad Lawrence tied up. Mohamed Cisse draws the penalty. That'll be pass interference, it looks like.
And remember we were talking about all the shots they were taking about down the field, the fade over the top? Well, that was one. It was either a back shoulder throw or a comeback route just to keep those Nebraska defenders honest.
Pass interference, number four, defense. 15 yards, automatic, first down.
Here's a look at the end of the play. You see Rashad Lawrence going head-to-head with Cisse. Just at the end, just grabbed his leg there, was kind of falling, slipping, trying to prevent that pass, and officials all over it.
It's got to be so hard for a corner not seeing the football when you're man-for-man. Counter handoff and Ankara there to blow up Venrick Mark. No gain on first down. Not every game has a happy ending, but every Tuesday on ABC does. TV's most fantastic comedy comes to Tuesdays this fall on ABC. So have a fun nightstand with happy endings. Premieres Tuesday, October 23rd, 9, 8 central on ABC. Second down and 10.
See the cushion they're giving them now down at the bottom of the screen? That's what happens when you run some deep balls.
Payne Coulter, more of a danger to run than Simeon, certainly picks up four. It'll be third down and six.
You know, we had talked a lot in the first half about how much Nebraska was challenging Northwestern's receiver, getting up there and pressing them. Well, Northwestern, they kept trying to take the fade route. They never hit it, but they did before the half. And then now you can see what happened. They had the play call there. Watch the defenders. Let's see if they stay up there or do they back off. Are they still going to press? Nope. Up top and getting a little bit more cushion, a little bit more leeway at some spots.
Simeon back in at quarterback on third and six. And this play blown dead. False start.
Prior to the snap, false start. Number two, offense. Five-yard penalty remains third down.
That's Kane Coulter. So now it will be third down and 11. We spent some time with Kane Coulter yesterday. How impressive of a young man is he?
He was so impressive to sit down with. Not only his knowledge of the offense, you know, going down and taking him in and breaking down some plays, but also just listening to what he's doing academically. You know, pre-med major, you know, having that load as well as being the man for Northwestern, pretty impressive.
He comes off the field now on third and 11. Four-man rush. Simeon, well protected. High ball to the sideline, incomplete. Christian Jones couldn't lay out to make that catch. Ciante Evans there in coverage, and Nebraska gets the stop. If you're Pat Fitzgerald's team, is the strategy now to just try and manage field position and win this game 21-10, or are you anticipating as much time as left in the game, you're going to have to score some more points to win it? Abdullah, fair catch at the 13.
You know, but I think this is a hard place to coach from. When you're up by 11, there's still a lot of time left. I think you still have to stay aggressive. Like they did that last drive, they took their shots down the field. You can't ever get tentative. You know, unless you're in a 4 minutes left to go in the game type of situation where you're trying to milk the clock, and you might start calling the game a little bit differently. But at this point, you've got to say, hey, look, Nebraska still has Taylor Martinez. You know, they've got Amir Abdullah. They've got, you know, Kenny Bell on the outside. They've got playmakers that can score just like that. So you've got to keep that offensive pressure.
And a two-possession game at 11 points. Certainly no reason for Nebraska to not be run heavy with their offense if that's the way they think they can go. They'll start this drive on the ground with Abdullah. Breaks a tackle, stays on his feet. That's a terrific run through traffic for Amir Abdullah for 15 yards and a first down.
You know, and talking to Pat Fitzgerald yesterday, he said, hey, my third level, meaning my safeties, my corners, are going to have to come up and make tackles. Because he was expecting plays like this. You see Amir Abdullah, there's a linebacker come flying up. But then the safeties are the last line of defense. They don't want to give up any big plays.
Abdullah, how about that spin move? Blown up at the 29-yard line.
And that was
still it manages about 4 yards out of the carry, and it looks like Van Hoos is hurt.
Yep, that was a third-level guy, a cornerback coming up. Made the initial contact, and of course he's the guy down on the field right now. But you cannot, you got to make sure you stop the runner. I know he went for the big hit, but you've got to make sure you make the tackle, wrap up, and stay wrapped up. That was Ibrahim Campbell, the safety, who came over and made the tackle.
Nick Van Hoos made first contact, spun Abdullah, and Abdullah showed terrific balance to shake that off and pick up about 3.5 yards.
Of course, it's easier to wrap up if you're not injured on the play.
So Van Hoos, who has 2 fumble recoveries on muffed punts today, is still injured. BCS countdown is on ESPN and ESPNU tomorrow. As Van Hoos is able to walk off the field, our analyst is going to break down all the big wins and losses, and we will reveal the new BCS standings. 8:30 on ESPN, followed by more coverage at 9 on ESPNU. It's the BCS countdown presented by Tostitos tomorrow on ESPN and ESPNU. So with one of their starting corners off the field now, Northwestern thin in the secondary, second down and 6 for Nebraska. Abdullah about 2 yards shy of a first down. Travion Henry, Daniel Jones combine on the tackle. It'll be 3rd down and 2.
This could be a great opportunity for Nebraska to sell a hard run fake and take a shot down the field. They've had their most success in the passing game has come off the play-action pass. You know Northwestern's expecting run, as everybody is.
Steven Osborne's the lone wideout. Tight to the near side left. Instead, they'll go right up the gut. Second effort. Abdullah short. Now it's 4th down and 1 yard at your own 38-yard line, and here comes the punt group.
Boy, nice job by number 10, Travion Henry, coming up for that stop, and that's that third level that Pat Fitzgerald talked about. Able to get up in there, recognize the run, saw the hard run sell by the offensive lineman, and came up and made the big 3rd down stop.
I would not want to be the man in the assistant coach's booth on the other end of that headset. And another big change of field position here. All the way down inside the 5-yard line, it's down at the 4. I'm not sure what Venrick Mark's thinking about.
No, he's
it's a 58-yard punt.
Yeah,
he let the ball sail over his head. And it ends up inside the 5.
Nebraska punt. That's a great opportunity there for them. Now, remember, he did have the issues in the first quarter where he kicked the ball around.
Let's take a look at our good hands play brought to you by Allstate.
Here's Christian Jones running the fade route right past number 16, Stanley John Baptiste, for the nice, soft hands for the reception. What do you always like as a quarterback? Have a guy who catches it like, you know, like you're throwing a soft egg at him. Way to look it in.
Well, here's a chance for the Nebraska defense to change the game. If you can get a stop and change field position. They start with a tackle after only a 3-yard gain of mark on first down. Damian Stafford came up to make the stop.
When you're out in midfield, it's easier to use that short passing game to kind of get your way out. But when you're backed up in here, you get a little bit nervous putting that ball in the air.
A roll out for Simeon in the end zone. High throw to the sideline. Contact. No flag comes out. Pat Fitzgerald begging for a flag for defensive holding as Ciante Evans tied up with Christian Jones. It'll be third down and seven from the seven.
A lot of contact there by Ciante Evans. Here comes number 40, Dan Vitale. They pass him off pretty nice. That's actually PJ Smith right there on the inside slot. Some contact there for sure.
Third and seven. Still Simeon at quarterback. And he wants help in the backfield from Venrick Mark. Four-man rush. Simeon, high throw again to the sideline. And the Huskers do their job. It's three and out. And Northwestern is going to have to punt from the end zone.
Well, that's about, they've tried the fade routes and they've tried that kind of inside corner route. But Ciante Evans is probably the guy that you do not want to be throwing against. That's one guy that Don Papuchis, the defensive coordinator for Nebraska, singled out, said, hey, he has been shutting guys down in the slot all season long. Even said he possibly could be their defensive MVP at the midway point of their season.
Kick that's angled to the near side. Fair catch called for at the 49-yard line by Abdullah.
But a great job by going and running that ball down, much like Venrick Mark didn't the last time. That could have been an extra 20-yard roll on that ball, so pretty alert by Abdullah.
Now the whole reason that punt comes from the end zone goes back to the fact that Venrick Mark couldn't do that for Northwestern. So now Nebraska with a big chance offensively late third quarter to start a drive in Northwestern territory.
We talked about the play-action pass being their most successful passes so far. Great down to call it is on first down.
Martinez, play-action fake to the sideline to Bell. Uses the stiff arm, and he's very close to a first down. It looks like he might have it. It is a gain of 11, and that's a Huskers first down.
A pretty nice alertness by Kenny Bell, recognizing where the first down marker was and tiptoeing his toes just in front of that marker to get a fresh set down.
On first and 10, Abdullah, nothing there. Forced back inside by Wabusi and finished off by Chance Carter. It'll be second down and 10.
It's interesting watching the two defenses play, you know, watching the way Nebraska gets up and challenges Northwestern's receivers and then watching the respect that Northwestern has on the flip side. You know, seeing them give a lot of cushion where you can take a lot of the short passing game just like they did the last down. Look at these. There's much more space in between the DBs and the wide receivers. You know, that quick passing game is there all day if they want it.
Instead, Martinez bluffed as if he was going to take off. And now he'll turn the corner and sling one up the sideline. Just before he crossed the line of scrimmage, he throws a strike. Tim Marlowe has a first down.
How about the play action to yourself? You know, selling the quarterback run and then just halting. That's so tough to defend if you're a defender. When you've got a dual threat at the quarterback position, a guy who can burn you with his legs, and then he pops back and kills you with his arm.
No Rex Burkhead out with an injured knee. Abdullah stays in the backfield next to Martinez. Straight run for Taylor Martinez. Breaks a tackle. Weaves his way into the red zone. Picks up about six to the 17-yard line as we go down to Maria.
Yeah, guys, cornerback Nick Van Hoos, he's actually walking off the sidelines right now. He has a shoulder injury and is questionable for return. So that means Quinn Evans is taking his place at the cornerback position right now.
Quinn Evans is the Stanford transfer. Only 5'10", 180 pounds. So you're giving away some size there. And some depth. Second and four. Martinez, wide open Bell. He's got a first down. First and goal, and out some more yards. A late hit out of bounds, and Kenny Bell's shaken up. Kenny Bell lucky to be able to get back up and shake off what was a tough hit out of bounds. It'll be first and goal at the three.
Personal foul, late hit, number 10 of the defense. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
Well, you know what's impressed me this drive is Taylor Martinez making good decisions. Here's one look at the late hit. There's Kenny Bell. He's kind of running a little inside bounce route. And then once he goes out of bounds, it's the extra shove there. Not too horrible.
That's when you get close to the pavement over there. Yeah. Though. That's dangerous.
Yeah. Taylor Martinez has engineered a pretty nice drive to bring it down in this territory.
Play action on first and goal. Martinez wants to run it in. And he's in. Touchdown, Nebraska. Sixth rushing touchdown of the season for Taylor Martinez. 1:09 to go in the third. Do you chase the point if you're Nebraska and go for two? Or do you make it a four-point game and kick the point after? Is it too early to try the two-point conversion?
No, I think they're going to try to get them right here and make sure you get that three-point game.
As far as points have been to come by today.
I like to do it more of a feel, too. And I think you've got to feel pretty confident with the way that drive played out. I mean, that was a long drive with a lot of successful plays on it. I think that should come into your decision-making process, too.
Well, they might have to call a timeout.
Yeah, they don't want to talk about this.
Now, they are going to line up and try for two as they get set. Only six on the play clock. Late getting the play call. Two-point conversion attempt. And now whistles. And a timeout may have been called. Bo Pelini and the Nebraska coaching staff not happy. Well, obviously, this is more than just a timeout being called by one team or the other. Let's get the call.
We're going to reset the play clock to 25 seconds. And start to try. Try only.
Now, I think that was a case where there was a mix-up in the ball on the field. I mean, they use a different ball for kickers. I think the officials had the wrong one, and Nebraska wanted to make sure they had the game ball that's used for regular offense.
So here's the two-point conversion attempt. Abdullah with an extra pitch to the edge to Hurd, and he won't get there. They run the handoff. And then an option with the two running backs. And Northwestern not fooled. No, it's still a five-point margin. Let's go back to the touchdown.
Look at the Taylor Martinez touchdown run. Watch the guard get out in front of him. Along with Amir Abdullah, number 8, kicks out number 44. And then Taylor Martinez able to turn it up and take it his own. That's one more look coming right at you. And that was a design Taylor Martinez run the whole time with a bunch of big bodies out in front.
All 49 yards on that drive accounted for by Martinez.
There's some of the action there going in front of him. Oh, excuse me. This is the extra point right here, running the option down the line. But Northwestern just stretching them down. If you're facing that option, you want them going sideways. The longer they're going sideways, the better chance you have of your defense catching up.
Are you sensing that Nebraska's offense physically is starting to wear down Northwestern's defense a bit?
On that drive, without question.
It'll be very interesting to see how Northwestern's defense holds against the Huskers' rush attack in the fourth quarter as Venrick Mark gets out to about the 23-yard line. So 1:03 to go in the third. It's a four game. And you've got the number one rush team in the Big Ten, number 5 in the country. And you can't put those kind of rush numbers up unless you have the ability to wear down your opponent physically, I would think.
Oh, without question. I mean, think about it. When you think of Nebraska, you think big, you think ground and pound. And that's exactly what they do with some athletic guys, some quickness in the backfield.
Coulter on the sideline, Simeon at quarterback. Right up the middle. Venrick Mark for 4 yards. It'll be second down and 6. And that takes us inside of a minute to go in the third quarter. Wants the home run ball again to Tony Jones. Incomplete.
Oh, he had him, too. Well, Trevor Siemian knew he had that Christian Jones had a step. That was Tony Jones, excuse me. Had a step on the defender, put some air under it, and just a hair overthrown.
That same matchup we've seen between Jones and Stanley Jean-Baptiste today. So now it's third down and six. What could have been a touchdown becomes a huge play for Nebraska's defense to see if they can get off the field. Huskers show blitz. They bring five. Simeon, again, a one-on-one matchup on the edge. And again, Northwestern can't hit the deep ball. Rashad Lawrence the target that time.
Well, I think it goes back to what Maria said that Pat Fitzgerald said at halftime. It was, hey, my guys are going to have to get athletic and make a play. I mean, Nebraska is challenging them, and they're trying to counter by going deep. And they hit it one time, and that's it. I mean, it's a low percentage throw. If you get it, it's a home run. You're probably going to score a touchdown. But it has been a challenge for Northwestern.
The 11th Northwestern punt. And this is a good one. Abdullah all the way back to his own 20-yard line, and he'll be brought down inside the 20. What a terrific punt by Brandon Williams. Quinn Evans made the stop of Amir Abdullah, but that was a 51-yard punt and a loss of three more on the return. Well, now to me, Danny, I think the most interesting aspect of this game becomes that physical question that we talked about. It's a one-possession game, so the clock not at all a factor. Nebraska, can they simply run the ball on this Northwestern defense?
And one thing Nebraska does is roll a lot of offensive linemen throughout the game. They're going to be fresh, and they're getting stronger as the afternoon progresses.
Taylor Martinez lets the blocking group take care of the traffic in front of him and picks up 8 yards out to the 25. And that should take us to the end of the third quarter. So we head to the fourth quarter. It's a 5-point game. Northwestern clinging to a 21-16 lead. Perfect afternoon just outside of Chicago. 21-16, Northwestern has the lead on Nebraska. ESPN College Football in the Big Ten. Bob Wischusen, Danny Cannell, and Maria Taylor here in Evanston. Plenty of Nebraska fans, as you can see, filled up Ryan Field. That Northwestern student section's made some noise.
They're starting to rock a little bit, realizing the importance this fourth quarter is going to play in this game. And their defense is going to have to step up.
So we start the fourth quarter, second down and short for the Huskers. Taylor Martinez has commanded a very balanced attack today. 182 rushing yards, 202 passing yards. They'll keep it on the ground here. And fighting for a first down is Amani Cross. We'll take a look at our Pacific Life game summary as Nebraska adds to their rushing total, but trying to shake off the three turnovers in the first half.
Oh, without question. If they didn't have those turnovers, you feel like Nebraska would be firmly in control of this game. Instead, they're finding themselves with a 5-point deficit. In Northwestern, you look at the 9-3 and three and outs. A couple big plays is really all they've been able to do.
Martinez off a play action fake. Hit and spun down. A sack back inside the 20-yard line. Drew Smith gets the takedown, and that's a big loss.
Well, Drew Smith on that line of scrimmage just able to beat the left tackle to the point of attack right there, Taylor Martinez. And that's a big stop because this is what they need to do. They need to get Nebraska off schedule. Nebraska's just been grinding them 3 and 4 yards a pop. You want them in long yarded situations like this.
Off to Abdullah, shakes and bakes out to about the 24-yard line. That'll still bring up third down and close to 14. And that physical advantage that we talked about, maybe Nebraska having to start off the fourth quarter, That's taken off the table when it's 3rd and 14.
Oh, without question. That's what they need to do, is try to get some more linebackers involved. Force Taylor Martinez to beat you strictly with the passing game. But he's doing a pretty phenomenal job. Decision making, working that zone read, taking what they're giving him. You know, that's going to be a challenge. But these are the types of situations you want to force Nebraska's hand.
One for 10 on the day on third down. The pocket starts to collapse again. Martinez tries to escape. Runs out of space and then fires one up the sideline. And the entire Nebraska sideline looking for a flag, and they get it. Tariq Allen, the intended receiver. What a job by Taylor Martinez to extend the play. Give his receivers a chance to help him out, and there are two flags down.
Phenomenal play by Taylor Martinez, just buying any kind of time. I mean, that play was dead. You thought they had him for a sack in the backfield, and just one-man effort right there. And then I thought he was going to run it, just try to run for the first down, and then he was able to pull up and almost made the circus throw.
Well, the question here is, do we have two separate fouls? If we have offsetting penalties, you'd have to replay 3rd and 14. Well, certainly the flag thrown from the secondary, that was the flag that the entire coaching staff and sideline for the Huskers was begging for. They got that call in the secondary. There's another flag down, though.
There are multiple fouls on both teams. Pass interference, number 27 of the defense. Ineligible receiver, number 77 of the offense. Those will offset. And we have a dead ball, sideline warning on Nebraska. That's a 5-yard penalty, fourth down. Replay third down.
But not only are you replaying third down, but if they're going to call that penalty after the play is over, that makes it 3rd and 19.
Here's a look at the scramble by Taylor Martinez. You see him, nice job stepping up in the pocket. You think he's going to take off with his legs. He gets outside of the defense. A nice stiff arm right there. But then he pulls up. He finds number 7. And here's number 77 right there. Way too far down the field. Officials all over it. And, of course, Bo Pelini and half of the Nebraska bench are coming out there trying to get the pass interference call. So they get busted also.
He wants his guys back, though, because the 5-yard penalty after the offsetting penalties makes it 3rd and 19. Another flag thrown at the snap. And Martinez bullets one up the sideline, and it's caught by Jamal Turner. He's got a first down at the play stands. There was a flag thrown at the line of scrimmage just after the ball was snapped. And it looks like it's going to be a shift against Nebraska. Oh. Taylor Martinez exasperated as he makes another extension of a play, and that'll get wiped out.
Illegal formation, number 71, was not up on the line of scrimmage. That's 5 out of the backfield. That's a 5-yard penalty. We'll repeat. Third down.
Well, it was clearly a passing situation, 3rd and 9. A lot of times those tackles like to give some depth to kind of give themselves an advantage going against a defensive end who's bringing that pass rush.
How much gray area do the officials normally give in terms of angling your body to those tackles?
It's a pretty rare call. It would have had to been real obvious for the officials to call it right there.
We've seen it twice, though.
Yes.
That's happened to Nebraska twice. That's 3rd and 24. And Martinez simply flings it down the sideline, incomplete.
Yeah, that was a situation where you throw it up. Maybe if it gets intercepted, it's just like a punt. Maybe you get a pass interference call there. But Taylor Martinez, can't ask him to do much more in those two plays. Just finding a way to make a play, and both those penalties really hurt Nebraska.
If Nebraska indeed loses this game, could you imagine having to watch this tape and go through all the different times in the game where they've hurt themselves? And that's out of bounds near midfield. Very good field position for Northwestern with a 5-point lead when we return. On the left, number 71, Jeremiah Searles, just heard it from Bo Pelini while we were away. The second time in the game that an offensive lineman has been called for being off the line of scrimmage for Nebraska, and it hurt the Huskers. Now in midfield, Kane Coulter dives into plus territory with a gain of 6 on first down. Will Compton made the stop. And now you just wonder, even if Northwestern Danny Cannell fails to score points on this drive, can they at least pick up a first down or two and eat some clock and keep their defense off the field?
And they need to give their defense a break.
And they go up tempo and right up the middle. Not much there. At least 3 yards shy of a first down is Venrick Mark. Are you also surprised that Northwestern isn't working the play clock a little bit more? They snapped the ball there with about 20 on the play clock.
I think it's still a lot of time left in this game. I think your best approach has got to be, hey, we have to stay on the offensive. Let's not get tentative. I mean, I've always been of the mind, hey, you've got to play to win. You can't play not to lose.
And Venrick Mark shaking up on that last play. So
I think a pretty key storyline in this game, too, is what Nebraska has been able to do with Kane Coulter, shutting him down for the most part. And that was a huge part of their game plan. You know, talking to John Papuchis was saying, hey, we have to find Kane Coulter at all times and eliminate him. And for the most part, he's been eliminated in this game.
Well, Coulter's a receiver now. It's Trevor Siemian back in, out of the shotgun on third down and 2. Kane Coulter to make the first down reception. Quarterback to quarterback. And that moves the chains for Northwestern to the Nebraska 36.
Here's Kane Coulter, lines up in the slot. And look at the feel. Watch him widen and stretch out. That's the benefit of kind of knowing the big picture, where he could find a space.
Siemian, comebacker to the sideline. Incomplete. Rashard Lawrence, the intended receiver, as we go back to Robert Flores. Got a tight one here as well, Robert. 5-point game. And Northwestern in plus territory, but they're facing third down again. A little underneath hookup between Siemian and Cameron Dickerson. A gain of about 3, maybe 4 yards. So it will be third down and 7. And a timeout's going to be called by Nebraska on defense. They couldn't get their personnel off the field, and Nebraska almost caught with 12 men on the field.
It's one advantage of going hurry up.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by K Jewelers. Every kiss begins with K. The Dr. Pepper Tuition Giveaway. Learn more at drpepper.com. And Firestone, reminding you that whatever you drive, drive a Firestone.
There was the School of Journalism's prediction as to what the final score would be. They were a little off, 70-2, but some notable alums that have come through the Northwestern School of Journalism include our own colleagues, Mike Greenberg, Brett Musburger, and Michael Wilbon, who joined us earlier to start off the second half. Big play here.
Somebody's got to win on the outside. Somebody's got to win one of these matchups.
Here comes a blitz. Siemian under pressure, buying time, tucks it under. He's going to try and run for it. The flag's down. He has the first down if the play stands. A flag thrown on the near side in the secondary.
Well, there was a lot of contact on those jams. Nebraska was up once again, pressing the wide receivers. There was a lot of contact down the field. But how about Trevor Siemian? The athleticism he showed by fighting his way for that first down.
Holding number 2, defense. 10-yard penalty from the end of the run results in a first down.
Another Nebraska penalty. Another player for Bo Pelini to get into it with on the sideline, and it looks like Antonio Bell is about as angry at Bo Pelini as Bo Pelini is at him, maybe more. Right up the middle goes Mike Trumpy.
Mike Trumpy
at the 10-yard line. A gain of 4 on first down. This is only the second time today that Northwestern has been in the red zone, and they've got a 5-point lead. Trumpy again. Out of the 7-yard line, it will be third down and three. Jason Ankra made the stop.
Talk about getting movement up front. Got to give some credit to Northwestern's offensive line. Those two plays right there, able to push Nebraska's defensive line and get some surge at the point of attack.
This is a huge play. Third down and three. Inside the 4-yard line, gives Northwestern a first down. They'll run it again with Trumpy. He might be just short.
Mike Trumpy, the ball carrier.
Let's see where they mark the football. And now what do you do if you're Pat Fitzgerald? Fourth down and a foot if our third down marker is right.
Well, you talk about feeling a call right there. Look at what Northwestern was able to do those first three plays. They got 3 yards of pop, but it's tough to walk away from points right here.
Here's the thing, though. If you don't go for it on fourth down and you opt to kick the field goal, it's only a one-possession game. It would take the lead from 5-8. If you go for it and eventually score a touchdown, well, now you've really got Nebraska in a hole. And it is exactly fourth down and a foot.
Pretty good call there, asking for the measurement, basically buying yourself a timeout while the officials are on the field with the chains.
What would you do?
I think Pat Fitzgerald's a guy who likes to live by the edge, but he's going to take the points. I tend to agree with him here.
Let's see. He's got Kane Coulter out there.
Oh, now he's going to.
They're going to go for it. They've got Kane Coulter with Mike Trumpy behind him.
He ran the quarterback sneak before. Remember, they tried to do the little shift, get them off sides. You can run something similar here. You got a QB sneak this. You only need inches, and Kane Coulter's pretty physical as it is. That's what I'd expect. Don't even give the ball, lose any ground in the backfield. Just let Coulter sneak it.
Fourth down and a foot. Let's see if Northwestern does indeed snap the ball. The head bob, just trying to get Nebraska to go offsides. He's back under center. He will snap it. And he gets stopped initially, but the second effort gets him the first down.
Wow. We talked about Kane Coulter and how well a job Nebraska had been containing him. This drive, he's made a couple big plays, none bigger than that fourth and inches. What you saw, Bob, was shut down, initial contact. Look at all those backers up in the gaps. Coulter's able to kind of feel his way around, improvise, and find that first down. Great individual effort.
So it'll still be Coulter to take the direct snap now on first and goal. Trumpy at the goal line, he's in. Touchdown, Northwestern. So many things in this game get affected by Pat Fitzgerald having the guts to pull the trigger on fourth down and a foot. And now, instead of it being a one possession game with Northwestern settling for a field goal, now they've got a 12-point lead. Not only is it a two possession game, but now Nebraska needs two touchdowns.
How about Northwestern getting physical on their own? Six consecutive run plays finished off by Mike Trumpy.
Northwestern Wildcats with the fall foliage surrounding a sold-out Ryan Field have taken control of this game here in the fourth quarter. And again, it is the self-inflicted wounds of Nebraska that have been as much of a story as the four different players that have scored the four touchdowns for Northwestern. Mike Trumpy with his second rushing touchdown of the season makes it a 28-16 game. Short kick comes down at the 10 to Kenny Bell. And Bell gets pounded right at the 20-yard line. We have the number one team in the land tonight on ESPN. A.J. McCarron and Alabama head to Knoxville to take on Tennessee at 7 Eastern. It's College Football Primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. Top-ranked Alabama, Tennessee tonight. It's also live on Watch ESPN and the Watch ESPN app. How much of a chance do you give Tennessee to hang in there tonight with Alabama?
If they can get Tyler Bray going, they've only surrendered 3 sacks to Tyler Bray all year long. Maybe they can challenge Alabama, but Alabama is as strong as they get.
Taylor Martinez, good run on first down as we go back to Robert Flores. That's an old-time Michigan-Michigan State Big Ten battle. 12-10, the final. Michigan wins it. And Northwestern trying to keep pace as best they can and stay along with Nebraska's one-loss teams behind Michigan. Still undefeated in their division here in the Big Ten. And that's a first down run a moment ago. So it's first and 10. Nebraska now at the 34.
Now's where Nebraska's offense, that ground and pound, almost hurts them because they're using up a lot of clock.
Taylor Martinez over the middle, tipped around, and I think intercepted. No, it falls incomplete. Three different Northwestern Wildcats had a chance to pick the ball off. And on the pinball, we also have an injury. I think that's Sean McKevely, who was down and injured. As we take a look at the ball, carom around, four different players had a chance to pick it off.
Yeah, it was Wabusi who tipped that ball up. And that happens so many times. You get all your same team going for the ball and almost knock it out of each other's hands.
Wabusi knocked it in the air. Damian Proby had a chance at it. He hit Wabusi on the carom. Sean McKevely trying to come back and pick it off from his defensive tackle position. He was hit by Proby also.
One more look at it. Ball's tipped in the air. Off a helmet, off a glove, off a mitt. That ball hit everything.
That's a dodged bullet for Nebraska. As McKevely helped to the sideline. So it's second down and 10. Taylor Martinez should have been picked off. Ibrahim Campbell had a chance maybe for a pick six, but lost his footing and couldn't hold on to the football. Now it's third down and 10.
The Northwestern defensive coordinator Mike Hankwitz said, we are going to get opportunities for turnovers. We have to capitalize. Two missed opportunities right there.
Martinez to the sideline, and that is good for a first down, a third and 10 conversion to midfield and Kyler Reed.
On here, Nebraska starting to hustle up. They definitely have to play with a sense of urgency, needing two scores in this game to get fight their way back into it.
Four-man rush. Martinez still under some pressure. Flips it to Abdullah, and he'll step out of bounds with a gain of 5. And that will stop the clock for the moment with 7:08 to go. And give Nebraska a chance to get set before the clock starts again. Now the officials roll the clock, coming up on 7 minutes remaining. And it's taken a while for the Huskers to get set. Bobbled ball by Anunwa, but he's got a first down.
What you're seeing Northwestern do right here defensively is just keep everybody on Nebraska in front of you. Let them take those short underneath routes all day long. Don't get deep for a touchdown and make tackles. Just let them use up that clock.
So Northwestern starting to exchange some yards for time. You saw defensive coordinator Mike Hankwitz there. First and 10. Martinez, well protected. Goes into triple coverage to Anunwa, and he's got it. What a throw by Martinez. Terrific catch by Anunwa, and it's first and goal.
Wow, and sometimes you just have to take a shot and trust your receiver to make a play, and that's exactly what Anunua did there. Look at him, knows he's going to take a hit. Actually, the Northwestern guys hit them each other.
Gain of 30 puts it inside the 10. First and goal at the 8. Martinez swings one wide and overthrew Abdullah. Well, Amir Abdullah is only 5'9", so hard to drop that little swing pass into your short running back over those big offensive linemen. It'll be second down and goal.
No, but an incomplete pass there is not the worst thing. There's a look at Anunua shaking up a little bit after that huge catch he made. And now with the incomplete pass, they're able to catch their breath a little bit. Nebraska is.
They've got Tariq Allen at the top of your screen replacing Anunua. That's where Martinez wants to go. Right up against the sideline. It's good for a touchdown. Tariq Allen. He came into today with one catch on the season. And now he makes it a one-score game.
Well, they went with a sluggo route. The X, slant, and go. A double move on the outside. Watch him right here. He's going to sell that and then go to the back of the end zone. Martinez with a little pump fake and a beautiful throw. Nice and high where only Tariq Allen could get it. Daniel Jones a little late getting there. And what a masterful drive by Taylor Martinez in this Nebraska offense.
Great drive. 10 plays, 80 yards, barely over 2.5 minutes off the clock. Nebraska still with 2 timeouts, 5:55 to go. So they can certainly kick it deep and let their defense go play. One more look at the touchdown.
Tariq Allen. This is one he will remember for quite some time.
.55 to go in the fourth quarter. Nebraska has been in this position before. They were down by 17 at home to Wisconsin in the third quarter and came from behind for what to this point their biggest win of the year when they beat Wisconsin 30-27. Their losses to UCLA and a couple of weeks ago hammered by Ohio State 63-38, but trying to come from 2 scores down in the second half again today at Northwestern. Can the Wildcats run a 4-minute offense? Benrick Mark out across the 20 to about the 22-yard line. ESPN College Football available anytime, anywhere on your computer or a mobile device via WatchESPN.com and the Watch ESPN app. So if you are with us right now on Watch ESPN, we welcome you to Ryan Fields here in Evanston. It's about 50-50 the crowd, though. You'd think this was a bowl game. And I think half the tickets went to Nebraska and half went to Northwestern.
I think it might be 60-40 for Nebraska. I mean, the crowd noise right now, the defense for Nebraska is getting them fired up. And hard to believe Northwestern is actually going to have to deal with some of the elements here in their own backyard.
And this is as close to a road environment as Northwestern can get. Quarterback draw. Kane Coulter picks up 3 yards as we check in with Robert Flores. Great news for Braxton Miller. Second down and 7 with Trevor Siemian in the game. He'll hand one to Mike Trumpy. And Trumpy picks up about 2 yards or so to make it third down and a long 4, close to 5.
Well, the last drive, remember Northwestern ran those 6 consecutive runs. They were able to get a lot of ground yardage to grind up that clock. It'll be interesting to see. Here, how much do they trust Trevor Siemian? Are they going to let him drop back and go through progressions and try to pick up the first down through the air, or are they going to keep it on the ground? Looks like here, empty backfield, let him throw it.
Third down and 4.
Kane Coulter right there.
Four-man rush. Siemian to the sideline. Some contact. Does a flag come out? The Northwestern sideline can't believe it. Kane Coulter, the intended receiver, and Ciante Evans. They're in coverage, and that is now 10 three and outs for Northwestern offensively.
Ciante Evans head-to-head with Kane Coulter. Gets up in him pretty good. And at the end there, did have some contact with his right hand. His offhand was definitely on the jersey.
Their feet got tangled a bit.
Yes, as well. But if you're a Northwestern fan, if you're Kane Coulter, I think you definitely could make a pretty solid argument. There could have been a flag there.
So not only is Nebraska going to get the ball back with plenty of time, but they should get good field position. Special teams has been an adventure today for both teams. Wobbly kick. Amir Abdullah lets it bounce and shouldn't get anywhere near it. And he won't. So that changes field position. Brandon Williams bounces it down to the 24-yard line. It's a 50-yard punt. So how important is this game? Well, this is a divisional matchup. Two teams, both with one loss. So the loser goes to two losses, with Michigan having survived against Michigan State at 3-0 in the Legends Division. So really, the loser of this game, for the most part, probably out of it.
Most likely eliminated. I mean, this atmosphere right now, it does have kind of a playoff feel.
Taylor Martinez to throw on first down. Wants the home run ball. High throw, and Menwa's got another.
Wow, Taylor Martinez has found his guy. Kenny Bell, for most of the year, has been his favorite go-to. But Quincy Enunwa, that's the second huge catch he's made. How about this one? Just climbs the ladder, goes and gets the ball at the highest point. And all Daniel Jones can do is watch.
A gain of 31 on that catch by Enunwa, and Quinn Evans.
How about Taylor Martinez, the second half he has had? Driving his team down the field, putting the ball in the air, doing it on the ground. Sure, Nebraska is breathing a sigh of relief a little bit that he was able to put that Ohio State game. That's how you evaluate a quarterback. How does he overcome adversity? He had his worst performance in their last game against Ohio State, bounces back with a strong one today.
299 yards passing now for Taylor Martinez. Talking to Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator, about everything that Taylor Martinez has gone through under the microscope. Said, look, Nebraska football, the starting quarterback is critiqued unmercifully at times. And now it's Taylor Martinez trying to put his team on his back and get a come-from-behind win. He's got a two-yard gain on first down. Now, Tim Beck said everyone's favorite player in the world is the backup quarterback. And Taylor Martinez has certainly had to go through that. It's a tough gig being the starter at Nebraska. But the junior now in position to maybe pull off a come-from-behind win. Second and eight. Wide open, Kenny Bell. And he is ruled to have his forward progress stopped inbounds. So that rolls the clock with 3:23 to go. C.J. Bryant, who just came in replacing Quinn Evans, made the tackle. Third down and two.
Now, Taylor Martinez is doing a pretty good job deciding when to take that shot down the field and when to check it down like he did there to Kenny Bell.
Third down and closer to three. First down catch again, and again it's Quincy Enunwa.
All right, Taylor Martinez, once again, there was a blitz coming, realized he had to get rid of the ball quickly. Found Enunwa in the flat for the big first down. And he has really found a rhythm. Once again, Northwestern just kind of playing everybody back here, keeping everybody in front of them, trying to buckle down when they get down here in the red zone. Taylor Martinez directing traffic.
Martinez looking for Enunwa again. Well, check that, Jamal Turner. Jamal Turner gets in between the safeties, and it's first and goal.
Well, that was the same throw he made to Enunwa before that got him blown up, just right between those two safeties in the middle of the field. Those safeties have got to get a little bit more aggressive. They're widening out.
There's a flag down. It looked as if Northwestern might have jumped early.
They were.
Offside defense, number 67. That penalty's declined. Result of the play, first down.
What a wild game. First and goal for Nebraska. 2:24 to go.
But how impressive has Martinez been on the last few drives for Nebraska?
Now, Nebraska should be in no rush at all. And Bo Pelini wanted a timeout, didn't get it. Martinez, end zone! Touchdown! Ben Cotton gives the Huskers the lead. While Bo Pelini was trying to call a timeout on the Nebraska sideline, the snap results in a go-ahead touchdown. So now the Huskers will go for two to try and make it a three-point game.
Boy, what can you say about Taylor Martinez? Looked firmly in command of this offense this second half, really settled down, made great decisions, has done everything that they've asked him to do.
Martinez to the pylon, broken up with 2:08 remaining. So Northwestern, plenty of time. They'll still have a chance. They'll need a field goal to win it. But Nebraska takes their first lead of the second half.
Here's a look at the touchdown pass. You can see Ben Cotton right here. Watch him block a little bit, then split the middle of the field. But watch these linebackers. He runs right between two defenders for Northwestern. They just couldn't pick him up. There was a little bit of a slow reaction. Splits him, and Taylor Martinez throws a perfect ball. That's called throwing a guy open right there. Letting Ben Cotton go over and get it. He throws it away from the defenders. What a perfect throw and catch.
Taylor Martinez is now 10 of his last 11, 140 yards and two touchdowns.
When you talk about getting the hot hand, you can kind of see it early. Remember he made those crazy scrambles? He was running around. I mean, that was pretty, the rest of the team really fed off of that, even though they didn't go for anything, but they kind of, they were enthused by their leader.
David Wabusi was shaken up. So now he has to be helped off and actually able to come off under his own steam. So that's good to see as we go back to Robert Flores. Robert, we might have another candidate for our player of the week. Taylor Martinez, 27 of 39, but 10 of his last 11 for 140 yards and two touchdowns. Some terrific quarterbacking here in the fourth quarter. And he brings his team from 12 points down midway through the fourth to take the lead with 2:08 to go.
Now Nebraska's defense is going to have to step up.
And Northwestern will have to start at the 25. Now the Wildcats have a kicker that hasn't missed this year. Jeff Budzien is 11 of 11. His long so far this year, 44 yards. Nebraska has doubled up Northwestern in terms of total offense. But the Wildcats have a drive in them. And it looks like they'll start with Trevor Siemian at quarterback.
Well, he's had the most success, and ironically, he's had the most success running the no huddle on the afternoon.
Low throw scooped up by Coulter. It's a gain of 8 on first down. And that will roll the clock under 2 minutes to go. Come back into the sideline, pulled in, stepping out of bounds, Rashad Lawrence with a Northwestern first down.
Oh, and sometimes you can throw these short yards, these short, quick-hitting routes, kind of lull that defense to sleep. Now, it's easier in the middle of the game. This type of situation might not be able to catch one deep, but sooner or later, you feel like you're going to have to take a shot for that big play.
Four-man rush. Siemian out of the pocket. Floats one down the sideline. Wide open. And making the catch is Lawrence. inside the 40. He got lost along the sideline. That's going to be a blown coverage for Nebraska.
Bob, I did a disservice to Trevor Siemian by calling him a pocket passer because he has shown the ability to elude that pass rush and buy that extra time, which puts such a stress on defensive secondaries.
Here comes the blitz. Siemian to the sideline, almost intercepted. Stanley Jean-Baptiste could have ended the game.
Well, Siante Evans came from a long way. Trevor Siemian knew he had to throw that ball, get it out of his hands. Jean-Baptiste with a missed opportunity there.
As we said, Jeff Budzien, the field goal kicker for Northwestern, a long this year of 44. So to equal his long, you have to get to probably about the 28-yard line or so for it to be a 44, 45-yard field goal. So Northwestern needs another 12 to 13 yards to be inside field goal range. Second and 10. Siemian will try and run for part of it and gets to the 36, where it will be third down and about seven.
And it's called a timeout. Yep.
So Northwestern will spend their first timeout.
Good timeout, not only to come over and regroup, but also to give your quarterback who just scrambled a chance to kind of catch his breath, get him over on the sideline, go over the situation here. It's a critical third down. You need quite a bit more yardage. I mean, I think you also remind him here too, hey, it's two down territory. We're going to, you know, we have a lot of time left. We've got two more timeouts. Just review the big picture situation with people at this point.
It's about a 53-yard field goal from where they are right now. So for most college kickers, it's not the NFL. You want to be inside 53 yards, certainly.
Without question.
But Budzien's career long is 44. So again, that is not only picking up a first down, but maybe two or three more yards beyond that, getting to the 27, 28-yard line to get him within what, at least based on his performance in games, is his range. So here we go after the timeout, third down and seven. Here comes a blitz again. And that is almost intercepted. E.J. Smith jumped in front and knocked it down. Vitaly was the intended receiver, so now Pat Fitzgerald has a decision to make. Do you try the first down, the fourth down conversion play, or you try Jeff Budzien from what would be a career long?
Not on a fourth and seven. The chances on a fourth. If it was fourth and one, you know, maybe you consider it, but then in that situation, you're a more makeable field goal anyway.
So Jeff Budzien, who is 11 for 11 this year, a long of 44, though, from 53 to give Northwestern the lead. Got a chance. Just misses.
Here's one more look at the kick, which had plenty of leg. Or did it?
It just comes that
to the right.
Close. I mean, by a foot. A foot to the right of the upright. And you're right, Danny. He had the distance.
Yep.
That would have cleared the crossbar. Now, there's a minute and 10 to go, and Northwestern still has a couple of timeouts. So, technically, it is not over yet. Nebraska still has to run plays. And Northwestern might put them in a position where they have to punt if they can keep them from picking up a first down. And they'll sell out to stop the run on first down. Pat Fitzgerald calls a timeout. It's a loss of one on first down. Amir Abdullah stopped behind the line, so it will be second down and 11 after the timeout and after we check in again with Robert Flores. Big 12, and what a game we've had in the Big 10. This game will not go to overtime, we know that, as it is either Nebraska holding on for a 29-28 win or Northwestern getting one more crack with the football. But how about if Nebraska does hold on, Danny, everything that they have overcome, all of the self-inflicted wounds that have nearly cost them this game, to have Taylor Martinez put on the performance he has in the second half and maybe pull off a come-from-behind win.
Oh, it speaks volumes to their perseverance, and Bo Pelini able to keep that team together and not point fingers at each other, but kind of to buckle down and come together as a group.
Abdullah brought down after a gain of about 3.5 yards. That will put Abdullah very close to the 100-yard mark in the game, if not over. And a timeout not called here by Northwestern. Looks like they're going to let the clock wind down and save their timeout for after third down. So Bo Pelini more than happy to let the clock wind down, as he'll be able to take it very close to 20 seconds or so to go before they'll have to snap it again.
Yeah, and they're not giving Taylor Martinez a play. It even looks like he might call timeout.
So third down and 8. Northwestern tries to bottle up Abdullah. They do, and they will call their final timeout. It's 17, down to 16 seconds to go. It'll be fourth down. Now, for Northwestern, do you try and set up any kind of a return, or is this just selling out to try and block the punt?
I think you sell out to block the punt. I think you try to bring heat as best you can. But they do have a return man back.
Well, with 17 seconds to go, if you return the kick, and maybe this only takes 9 or 10 seconds, you leave yourself maybe with a chance to snap the ball, get to the sideline, and potentially set up for a long field goal.
We saw Bud Zeem with the strong leg he's got.
Just missed from 53. But certainly it looks like Northwestern is bringing a group to try and block the punt. And Kenny Bell's going to move back inside rather than be a gunner and help protect his punter, Brett Maher. Gets it away. Good protection by the group, special teams group, and a fair catch called for. Bobbled, and then jumping on top of it is Mark. Check that CJ, or rather Tony Jones, back to return the punt. So now you've got 8 seconds to go, no timeouts. So most likely only one snap for Northwestern.
Yeah, this is rugby time. Yeah, you go out there, you throw it down the field, start the hook and ladder, just start pitching that ball, try to keep it alive, and hope for a miracle.
It was an ugly day for Nebraska, but they're 8 seconds away from pulling off a 2-touchdown comeback in the fourth quarter. Simeon over the middle, broken up. So one more try for the hook and ladder with 2 seconds to go. Kane Coulter, the intended receiver.
And how about Nebraska never showing any sense of panic? You know, early in this game, there were, what was the deficit?
Well, they were down 12 in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they were down 12 in the fourth quarter and just stayed cool, stayed calm, didn't panic offensively or defensively.
Fumbled snap by Coulter. Picks it back up, and now he's running for his life. Needs some help. Stays behind the line of scrimmage. Throws a jump ball cross field. And it's knocked down. And Nebraska does indeed pull off a tremendous come-from-behind fourth-quarter win. Unless the officials say the game is not officially over.
On the offense, their penalties decline. Game over.
And that does make it official. So Bo Pelini's team survives about as many self-inflicted wounds as you could have and still win the football game.
And that look on his face speaks volumes. See that sigh of relief he's had? Was he went over to talk to Pat Fitzgerald?
So this certainly keeps Nebraska alive as they stay only one game in the loss column behind Michigan and Iowa in the Legends division as we head down to Maria.
All right, Coach, you lose Rex Burkhead in the first quarter, a couple of self-inflicted wounds. How did you keep this team together to get the victory?
I'm proud of our team. They kept battling. That was a heck of a game. That was a crazy game. And good for TV, not good for the heart. But proud of our team. They kept fighting, didn't give up. And I give a lot of credit to that Northwestern team. That's a class program.
Taylor Martinez kept a lot of plays alive for you in that second half. How was he able to build a rhythm offensively in the second?
You know, Taylor played his butt off, and we were our own worst enemy at times today, and we got to get some things cleaned up. But I'll take the win on the road and go back to work. And Taylor was a big part of that, obviously.
All right, thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, Maria, thanks very much. So Taylor Martinez, a terrific fourth quarter. And once again, our final. Nebraska wins it 29-28. Back to the studio now, and John Saunders.